Check, 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 check. 1, 2, 3. Check, check. 1, 2, 3. Check, check. Check, check. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
Check, check. 3, 2, 1. We have sound. Poggies. So Poggies is a is an emo.
Okay.
You know those frogs? Pepe. Oh, by the way, hello everyone. Sir Simdu.
Hi guys.
Venti, Daffy, Min.
So these are all your peoples.
Yeah, they're my besties.
Okay.
We're besties. Yeah.
Hi besties.
There was a real bestie. Kelly. Tomaki is a bestie. Best Maki.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, welcome besties. Get ready for art battle. It's going to be just a massive amount
check,
of
check.
Fun. And we're going to have 12 artists painting live in rounds of 20 minutes. So they'll have 20 minutes to
That's
go
more
from
than my fingers.
Yeah, 20 minutes
wow.
blank canvas to finished piece. And yeah, it's going to be epic. The audience votes. So you guys should definitely get registered to vote. You can do that
at our link
here.
Yeah.
Artbattle.com/vote. And you'll register with your phone number and you'll get a unique text link. I'm going to move the camera.
Yeah.
We should move it, or do you want to switch the...
Yeah, we can move it over a little bit. I don't like making eye contact with them.
Okay.
Yeah, they're very suspicious.
Okay.
Yeah.
They're sus.
They're sus. Yeah, you get sus. Yeah,
okay.
They're sus. Yeah. You can make eye contact with them. I don't want to.
Okay. Well.
But hello.
I'll need the camera to be where we're watching the video. So
okay.
Let's see what it looks like.
Oh, that's perfect. Yeah. Oh yeah, we could make that chat. Yeah, you're right. Oh, this is perfect. Yeah, sure. Let's do a switcheroo.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think this is better. Well, we can just stay here because we gotta.
We stay here, so we look at ourselves.
Yeah. But we're
because
not
we're
looking
so good
at
looking.
Ourselves because this is gonna be the.
Oh, it's gonna
be
okay. But they'll be able to. So they don't see us either.
They'll see us.
Yeah.
But we're gonna be really small. So
I am very small. Ryan, did you like the art I made you earlier? What art did you make for me earlier? Also, hi Titan, hi. Girl bestie, Kelly. I'm wearing my art shirt. The deli artist.
Sorry guys, just figuring out my setup here.
Titan, feel free to test it out, but I don't think so. This is pretty much the next best thing next to coming here. being here.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. In some ways it might actually even be better.
Yeah.
Because you guys are gonna actually get to see the camera like right up close to the easels,
right,
like inches away from the canvas, whereas the audience that's actually in the room are gonna be a few feet back. Yeah, and they get to hear our lovely commentary, whereas all of the people, the peasants, just will...
he redeems stand-up. Do you think I need to stand up?
Do you need to stand up?
Yeah, the Dabby, he asked me to stand up.
Okay, you can do that.
I can stand up, okay. So, Morgan?
Yeah.
She's a real artist.
Yes, I am.
Yeah.
I'm an oil painter. You guys can check me out on Instagram at Morgan Booth Art if you want.
I'm going to sit down. Thank you. Don't thank me. Thank you. You want to redeem Choco, but it's so expensive now. Yeah, but I don't even have Choco here, Venti. I would love to. I wish I can show you their setup. It's very high tech. It's the real deal. I like to say I like to thank my mom. AJ, hello.
You guys know this guy?
Is this your special?
Yeah. We haven't started yet. This is just a warm up, guys. Take it easy. Grab a drink. Grab some food. Buckle in. It's 3 hours, okay? But we normally stream for longer than that anyway, so 3 hours just passes by.
Shout out to my mom. Thanks for Ryan for bringing me here.
We love our moms.
I love my mom too.
Yeah. This is the highest quality Ryan Lou stream ever. Yeah, normally.
Yeah. What are you doing usually?
I'm just in my. So I started in my bedroom.
Yeah.
Not only fan stuff, but like.
Yeah.
But I had a computer there. Yeah. Just a webcam. That's it. I was playing games.
Mm-hmm. So are you used to being on camera or no?
Yeah, I'm like, what's the worst they can do? Right? They just say some hurtful stuff to you. Yeah.
Or we could fall off the stage. There's stairs behind us. Yeah.
Do you want to switch?
No, it's good. I'm used to being here.
That is scary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Living dangerously.
We're putting our lives on the line for you guys.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. Bring you the best content.
So we've got some really, really sick artists tonight. So not only is this art battle, but it's also,
All-Star.
Yeah, well, it's the championship event.
Oh, it's the championship
Yeah, it's
event.
The Toronto championship event. So each event and one single artist is crowned the winner. And we do this once a month. And
yeah.
I think we get cut off every time he talks, which is good.
Yeah.
And we do this once a month. And prior to the pandemic, we had a season that had half finished. So all of those artists who had won events in 2019 and 2020 but didn't get a chance to do the championship event because obvious reasons are here tonight. So it's really been a huge buildup. So we have this season and the pre-COVID season, and these guys have been waiting for a long time to get at the easels and rip around.
Who are you most, who do you think will win?
Ooh,
yeah.
That's a dangerous question to ask because I'm friends with all of them too. But seriously, one of the artists, and I'll even hold this up to the screen.
Wait, wait,
you
number them over there.
Yeah.
So you already know who's going to win.
No,
this
No. That's the easel number that they're in, so we know who to talk to.
Okay. Yeah.
So
it's not scripted,
all
guys.
Of this. Yeah. Is for one artist where it says winner, 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 finalist, and that's Natasha Deschpan. So she's going to be at Easel 1 in round 1. She has won, I think, 11 times, and I'm pretty sure almost every other battle that she's been in, she's also been a finalist. So if she hasn't won, she's made it to the final round. And
I bought one of her paintings.
Oh, yeah? Which one?
The blue guy.
Oh,
the blue,
yeah, yeah.
Guy.
From last month?
After.
Yeah, yeah. From,
not
last,
from
month,
last month?
Or
I think it was like half a year ago.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she
I loved
some
it. I wish I got the wolf,
sick
too.
Work.
Yeah.
Well, she might paint a wolf tonight, so we'll see.
Oh.
You'll have to stretch your bidding fingers.
She specializes in wolves, right? It's one of her specialties.
Yeah. But, yeah, so she's incredible. Another artist that I'm really excited about and is basically on that level of number of wins that she's had is Katrina Canedo, and she's going to be in round number 2, and she, like, annihilates.
Yeah.
But
I'm very excited about Natasha and Katrina.
Yeah, for sure. And there's also there's a couple of artists in here, too, who...
Washington.
That's going to...
Water Closet?
I've got... WC on our list here, and that's actually going to be a wild card. So
wild,
we're going to choose.
Card.
So,
wow.
At the door, people can enter their name for a chance to paint.
There?
Then you'll be hosting by yourself. Then you'll be hosting that round by yourself, unless we get me mic'd up.
Final two.
Oh, that's kind. That's kind.
Yeah.
I used to do art battle, and I have won a couple of times before, but not for many, many years. And the talent pool tonight is really intense, so I don't think I'd wanna throw my hat in the ring tonight. But it's going to be a really, really stiff competition for sure.
See, like normally I make a lot of like innuendos jokes.
Yeah. Yeah.
But I shouldn't anymore because we're very PG-13, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. More or less.
Yeah. Am I able to say hi to the folks?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Hi Jamal. Hi Dylan, aka Dillion. Apollo, who's right here. Wendy, Gianni. Holy crap! This setup. Just wait. So we're gonna have a man on the floor, right? He's gonna be walking around.
It's not gonna be our beautiful faces for that much longer.
Beautiful faces.
We're an attractive pair, for sure. Look at us. Our beautiful faces.
I don't know,
Ryan. Looking good, looking good.
Ryan brought his own bodyguard to look. He's here to protect us.
Yeah, amazing.
Lolo is here to protect us. Brent, you're here to protect us.
Yes.
You're fun. We're perfect. Perfect.
I locked your phone. In a minute, can you unlock it?
She just doxed. I'm pretty sure she just doxed. You understand the term dox?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure she just doxed. You're going to need to change that code after this.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. Someone's on it right now.
Yeah, I'm getting the hack. So what are you excited about seeing tonight?
Everyone. But I know...
Yeah, who do you know on the list?
I only know Katrina.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's a slayer.
Natasha, Sal.
Yeah, and Lois was here last month, and she won. And that's when I met you for the first time at Drinks After.
Yeah. It's nice meeting you.
Yeah.
That I met one of the girls there. I think she was sitting close to you, maybe.
Canedo? Katrina?
No, Tab, I think. Anna? I met her through Twitch, surprisingly.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah. So maybe we'll see her here. I wanted her to be here. But
yeah. Well, she can come in and say hi.
Yeah. What time do we kick off? Like around 8?
Yeah, we're going to go live at 8. So if you want to take a...
very fast.
Yeah. If you want any break time between rounds...
Do we drink on the job or no?
Take it for you right here.
Oh!
Okay, so I think that we are just going live on Facebook and YouTube right now as well. So welcome everyone to Art Battle Toronto streaming. This is going to be an absolutely epic night of live competitive painting because not only is this Art Battle Toronto, which is usually a really, really talent-heavy night, but this is actually the Toronto City Championship. So one artist will be crowned the winning artist tonight and will move on to the 2022 Canadian National Championship taking place on July 20th in Toronto. So really, really high stakes tonight. Our artist lineup is absolutely insane. As I was saying, all of these artists have either won or, yes, they have won events before. And we're actually, all of these artists are coming together cumulatively from the season that was pre-COVID, and our previous city championship event got canceled. So these guys have been waiting since pre-COVID to have a chance to compete in the city finals. So here they are, and that's about half of the artists painting tonight. And then the other half are artists who have won in the last 8 months in this current season. So it's going to be really crazy. We've got some absolute Art Battle celeb level artists. One to watch out for tonight is Natasha Deshpande. She has won, I think, 11 events and has been a finalist in almost every other event that she has been in if she hasn't won. Same for Katrina Canedo, who will be painting in round number two. We've got a couple of artists that are newer to the scene, but no less impressive. Especially I love it when an artist wins their very first battle. That's a special, special type of magic. And some artists who did that were Katie Lorraine, who's in round number one, and Matt Casson as well. And another artist to be excited about is Ray Maziri, a.k.a. Madeo. He was our artist that painted on the Porsche Taycan that we had a big Porsche-sponsored event in September 2021. And he actually painted directly on the car. So that was a really just absolutely epic time.
Hello, Morgan. Yeah. Tap, 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 tap. Okay, well, yeah, a little better, right?
Hey.
Okay, we're too yonked out here. Hello, 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 hello. Maybe it's me. Are you hearing only in your left ear?
Sorry, I'm hearing only in my right ear.
Hello, testing. Testing, 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 testing. Test, 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 test. Test, 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 test. Well, that's annoying. Thanks for sticking with us, everybody, through this audio testing. Hopefully you guys can hear us okay. Can you hear? Hear, test, test, test. Hello, hello? I'm not sure, to be honest with you. Is it? That's not usually the way it is, right? You can usually hear it in both ears. Oh. Okay. Well, as long as it's working as everybody expects, we're going to go to video feeds from Venue now. Yeah. Oopsies, not that one. Oh, yeah, and then just turn four back on. I'm going to put this up here. And let's just turn this off.
Can I put post credits, or is that going to clog things?
I don't think we should do anything. You can put them on. You can put host credits on. You just got to take them off later. Oh. Can you have what?
My phone back.
Yes. Here you go. I might need it later, but there it is for now. That's Chris Perez painting up there. Okay, we're back here. Anybody, I'm looking forward to talking to the folks in the chat. Adventil, nice. What's Poggies? Okay, here we go. Nice, good crowd action. Hello. Testing. What the? This should be coming out of both ears. Test. Morgan, could you say something? Yeah, that's better. There we go. Left and right. Could we? Left and right. Okay. Love good sound. Good sound is so key. You're going to put one da-da-da-da. Can you hear me okay in both ears?
Yes, I can.
Okay, I'm going to turn you up a bit. Say again, huh, Morgan?
Yes, I can.
Okay, nice.
Sounded good.
Okay, I'm going to get Ryan back.
Okay.
He's better at this than me. Everybody have a great show.
Welcome to our audiences that are just joining us now. We are here at Art Battle Toronto for the City Championship. So all of the artists that are going to be painting here with us tonight have previously won an event and have earned their spot in this championship event. So we are going to have 12 total artists competing across three rounds. Two qualifying rounds, each 20 minutes. The top two artists from each qualifying round will move on to the third and final round, where they will paint again, and this time they will have 30 minutes on the clock. So one artist will be crowned the winner, and we'll move on to the 2022 Art Battle Canada National Championship taking place in Toronto on July 20th. Right now, this is artist Chris Perez. He is our opening artist, and look at how gorgeous this piece is. This piece is absolutely stunning. Chris often does kind of these abstracted florals.
Yeah.
Really mixing, like...
I love all the colors.
Yeah, and like the graffiti elements with kind of this more traditionally what you would think of as being kind of a feminine and soft subject matter. But he brings it into this different kind of very contemporary realm.
Ah. Learning so much. This is so sick. Yeah, man, this is amazing. This is amazing. I can't wait. I honestly can't wait for you guys to see this, because it's incredible. It's incredible. It's amazing. The music is amazing. The atmosphere is amazing. The artists are great.
Oh yeah, our DJ is great.
Yeah, everyone's great.
And the crowd is popping. We've got lots of people coming in, and I think that we're gonna have even more.
I heard the line is huge outside.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. So if you want to come, I would say make it out right now.
Yeah, for sure.
Come down right now.
I love hearing that. I mean, it's terrible for the people that are actually outside in the lineup, but I love hearing that the lineup is around
up
the
too.
Block.
Yeah.
And this event is also
juxtaposition?
So juxtaposition is when you're having two elements that would be known as opposite. So the way something juxtaposes another thing is the way that it's highlighting difference, but kind of coming together at the same way or at the same time. And yeah, Fuel, I love it when people ask me about the art jargon. So if you guys want to know any of the stuff that I'm talking about, I'll try to explain it as I'm talking so that I'm not just in like total art jargon world. And I love answering questions like that too.
I'm just here to learn.
Well, I'm sure that you'll have a bunch of awesome insights.
Imagine
as well.
I'm just one of the chatters.
Okay.
But I'm here.
No, you're going to be my supporting partner. I'm relying on you.
I'm here to bring you drinks. Cheers.
Yeah, I'll cheers you with my Red Bull first.
Hello, Alex. I used to come here a lot with Alex, too.
So Alex is the artist, or is the person that I met last month, too, right?
No. Unfortunately, no. He hasn't been coming out to these anymore. Mm-hmm. He just watches the live stream.
Oh, nice.
Just like you said.
Awesome.
You can just enjoy it at the comfort of your own home.
Oh, wonderful. Right? Well, hi, Alex. Thanks for joining us again in the live stream. I never know how many people are watching when we're on, so that's nice.
I think there's give or take plus or minus a million.
That seems more intimidating.
Yeah. Ten people.
I hope that we go back to Chris's piece because I want to kind of get.
Yeah. Are we timing him too?
He's been given a loose 30.
Okay, so he has more time than everyone else.
Yeah, so he's just basically kind of the opening act for people to come in and see that there's some cool art going on. And this is Tanya and Chris. They are our MCs. Tanya has been our MC for a really long time. And Chris is actually one of the Art Battle co-founders.
Wow. And this event is sponsored by Porsche Canada?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, fancy. I think we actually have a Porsche outside the venue right now that maybe the people in the lineup that's wrapping around the block are taking pictures with them.
They can go take it for a test drive?
No.
No test drive.
I don't think our event insurance is good enough for that.
Yeah.
But, Porsche has sponsored a bunch of Art Battle events. The most notable was in September 2021, we actually had an event where artists were painting directly on Porsche Taycans.
Yeah. I saw that, too.
That was sick. That was a really cool
And
event.
They were very contrasting, too, in the style, like what they did with the cars.
Yeah, we had one artist that was very super colorful and painting a bunch of figures. And then the other artist, the artist that actually won and who will be painting tonight.
Yeah.
Ray Mazzuri, a.k.a. Madeo. And he is a calligraphic artist who specializes in large-scale work. So it'll be maybe a little bit more of a challenge for him working tonight on this small canvas.
Yeah. Oh. What is he doing now?
Looks like we're...
Is that a signature?
Yeah, well, it does say Chris now that I'm noticing. That's. I feel like he's going to layer over that, though, and kind of obscure it.
Okay.
I like the addition of the black over top of all of these really bright, saturated colors. I think it's creating a good contrast.
I'm seeing the female body underneath.
Are you?
Am I?
Okay. Right there?
Yeah,
I kind of see that, too.
Yeah.
What do you guys see?
I've never seen a female body before. I wouldn't know. And we're also streaming on YouTube,
yes,
where you guys normally stream.
Yeah, we're on YouTube and Facebook right now.
Yeah.
And definitely want to take an opportunity to remind everybody that
subscribe to the YouTube channel.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, but also artbattle.com/vote is where you're going to register to vote.
Yes.
That's basically the most important part of tonight, and something that we hear
all the
time.
This is completely interactive.
Yes.
You guys have the power.
Yeah, they're going to vote.
Yeah.
And we hear all the time that the difference between a winning artist can be as little as one vote, and that happens all the time.
Every vote counts.
Yeah, every vote super, super counts. So, and when we're thinking about what's going on tonight, It's a really, the stakes are really high in that the winning artist for tonight is actually going to be moving forward to the Nationals. So when you're voting, picture your artist that you want to win. Picture how good they're going to feel going to Nationals, painting with all of the other artists from around Canada, and like really just like vote.
Yeah.
I'm going to sound so cheesy, but you got to vote with your heart in this one because it's going to create an impactful life experience for whoever ends up at Nationals.
Then I'm very biased.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. So who are you thinking? Who does your heart want to win? I'm not painting.
my heart is already set.
But you're not going to give it away?
No, of course not. No spoilers.
No spoilers. Yeah, I don't even, it's hard, especially because I've known so many of these
only
artists.
Only one
so
gets
long.
To go to the Nationals?
We might have a special announcement later that could possibly change that, but as I've been told now, one artist going through.
That's just, that's not enough. Because there's a lot of great artists here.
Yeah, and it's our hometown, right? So Nationals is happening here in Toronto. So whoever wins tonight,
come back a month later.
Yeah, come back a month later, but also have the added pressure of representing their hometown.
True, they have to win.
Yeah.
Yeah, they will
but
win.
Only one.
Only one. What happens if there's like some kind of tiebreak? Do they fight it out with their brushes?
We have had physical fighting painting events before. Mm-hmm. I think you remember me telling you about that.
Yeah. Is that frowned upon now?
Well, yeah. Okay. I think we're too big.
What if we just splatter paint on each other?
We could do that.
Okay.
Establish kind of a splash zone.
Okay.
But yeah, for a tie, I guess it would have to be both going through, and we'd just have to make room. But
let's hope so.
Yeah. But so that would be if there's a tie in the final round. If there's a tie in one of the qualifying rounds, then we have extra canvas on site and we'll put a fifth person into the final.
I don't think I've ever seen a tie happen before.
I have. It's
you
intense.
Have.
Yeah, it's intense.
Oh. It's, maybe we'll see it today. Sudden death.
Yeah, it's funny because it's intense in the way that these artists are trying so hard to win, but I've never seen anybody be upset that it was a tie. They were just like happy for each other.
Of course, yeah.
Yeah, which is really sweet.
Fair like, than not
what
be
kind of
in
sports
the tie.
Does that happen in? Like where people are
true.
Happy for the other people to win.
I think the whole art community I'm seeing is like everyone's very close.
Yeah.
Very friendly with each other.
Yeah, for sure. And a bunch of these guys know each other, and then there's a bunch of artists that are kind of newer to the scene. And they're embraced just as much, for sure.
Did you see what Chris was doing?
No, what's he doing? Oh, we're getting our camera over there now. Looks like he's finishing up now.
Looks like he's almost done, right? Yeah.
I think so. I think I just saw him wiping his knives.
It's a very wholesome community.
Yeah.
Very wholesome community. Everyone supports each other.
Yeah, is that the vibe that you've gotten every time that you've attended in person as well?
Yes. Awesome. I love wholesomeness. Yeah.
your audience is like...
I'm very hippie. No, my I think but you don't talk to the YouTube chat. Because there's also a YouTube chat, right?
No, I've usually got a lot of streams and things to, or like a lot of software and stuff to deal with. And we don't, our YouTube chat doesn't tend to be that active. We do have one of our battle headquarters people, Gina, who's the artist manager and voting manager. She likes to pop in there sometimes. Shout out to Gina. Yeah, Gina's the best.
She's a bestie.
She is a bestie. She's definitely a bestie. And she really helps keep the Art Battle world running. She manages artists from all
guys,
over the place.
We got to keep Art Battle going.
Yeah.
I love Art Battle.
Yeah, we have...
Make it bigger.
It's pretty big. We have one coming up.
Make it even bigger.
Yeah, blow it up.
Yeah.
We have one in Belgrade, Serbia, coming up on Friday.
Wow.
Yeah. and the Ottawa Championships happening at the same time. So, yeah, lots on the...
Yeah, you guys are worldwide.
Worldwide.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you go to all these locations?
No, I'm just I'm doing this out of my my studio with my dog.
Yeah.
Hanging out with me, and
I have
just
a dog
watching.
Too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, my mom is dog sitting tonight.
Well, shout out to Ryan's dog. What's your dog's name?
Einstein.
Shout out to Einstein.
Love Einstein. Really cool that you're connecting one wholesome and PG community with another by streaming this on your channel. Yeah, my yeah. Thank you. Of course.
Yeah, thanks for sharing, Ryan. Got a good looking crowd.
Always. We're in Toronto.
I know. There's so many absurdly
the best
attractive
looking
people.
Are
featured stage painter tonight.
Here's the
and we're going to be auctioning this painting off with 100% of the money going to an amazing charity, Project Sunshine, which delivers programs to kids in hospitals. So this painting tonight is going to be auctioned off for Project Sunshine. Thank you to Chris Perez for taking part in that. I'd like to also give a shout out to our sponsor tonight, Porsche Canada and Porsche Centre North Toronto are helping to bring you Art Battle here tonight, and we are so proud to be involved with them. They are going to be the major presenting sponsor for the national championship this month, the Porsche Canada times Art Battle National Championship 2022, which is happening in 3 weeks and 1 day at the Liberty Grand Ballroom on the Canadian Exhibition Ground. So that's very exciting. Thank you, Porsche Canada, for being here with us tonight. We are proud to have you here, and I will definitely be imagining that I am driving a Porsche on the way home tonight. That's as close as I'm going to get. Her bold palette and energetic brushstrokes are a celebration of color and dynamic storytelling. Kicking off the city championship, please welcome Natasha Deschpan. Shining in the spotlight at easel number two, an artist equally skilled at naturalistic and abstract styles. He is the winner of Art Battle Toronto from November 2021. Please put your hands together for Stefano Beauvais. And at easel number three, with a penchant for bright colors and combining styles, please welcome multimedia artist and October 2021 champion, Katie Lorraine Paquette.
At easel number four, he's a Filipino-Canadian artist combining elements of his Asian heritage with Western influences for an exciting graffiti-esque approach.
Champions who are painting in the city finals. The top two artists, as voted by you, the crowd, will move on to the third and final round to paint again. So something to keep in mind while you're watching these artists is, one, to get registered to vote at artbattle.com/vote, and two, think about who you're enjoying watching painting and who you want to see paint again. So, all right. Right now, We are watching Anthony van der Toon, and I can see that he's doing some really quick sketch work with, I think that's a Sharpie.
Yeah, that looks like a face.
Yeah, we're getting kind of this abstracted face, lots of angularity here, and again, this is a 50-second drawing. So pretty impressive already.
I don't think I can draw that in 20 minutes.
I don't know. Okay, and then this is the artist known as Soul. And Soul is one of our newer winners. So this is actually only his second art battle ever.
Really?
He won his first ever art battle.
I saw him at the first one.
Yeah, and just slayed it. I remember being so excited when his application came in.
Soul?
I was just, yeah,
excited?
Soul excited. Ryan, we're going to get along so good. I love a good pun. And this is Katie Lorraine.
I saw she draw a donut last time.
Yeah, and I feel like we might be getting another
some
food
kind of pastry.
Treat.
Yeah.
Yeah, what do you think?
I love pastries.
What do you guys think? Out in the internets.
What do you guys think she's drawing?
I think I know. I never want to call it too early, though, and then
ruin
the surprise for everybody else.
Oh, because, yeah.
I feel like, should I say it? Maybe next time.
No.
I'll say
it on
the next
show. Spoilers.
And then, who is
this is nice. I love, just scenery. It's very calming.
Yeah. Oh, this is Stefano Bove. And Stefano is really well known for doing landscapes, and also really well known for definitely leaning into the blue. So I think we're going to see a really blue-heavy landscape from him there.
So far, we've only seen blue.
All blue.
Yeah,
all blue.
You're right on key.
Ooh, and here we are with Natasha.
Wow.
And Natasha was the artist that I was telling everybody to kind of watch out for.
Yeah.
Because she's one of.
You
the
think
most
she's going to win it all?
I think she has a really good shot. She's one of the winningest artists in Art Battle ever. And if she makes it through, it won't be her first time at competing at the national level.
Mm.
And we can see that she's kind of roughing in a face right now. What are you thinking of these colors?
I love purple.
Me too. It's like leaning into this really like kind of fuchsia too. I like it. Okay, and here we're getting more naturalistic skin tones, and this is Lois Mata. And she
a lot
was
of
the
faces.
Most, yeah, she was the most recent winner. And we see a lot of faces because that's what the crowd likes, man.
I thought they loved bulls.
They do love bulls, but
right?
I have seen bulls win a few times.
Yeah, because stomps.
Yeah, just stomp in the art battle.
Yeah.
But portrait painters tend to do really well. We always say that a landscape artist or an abstract artist has to paint twice as good as the portrait painter next to them.
Why do you think that is?
Just because people are so easily able to connect with faces.
Yeah. We all have a face.
Yeah, exactly. We all have a face.
Yeah.
So we like seeing
good or
faces.
Bad.
Yeah, it lights up our mirror neurons.
Yeah.
So with a landscape or an abstract, it has to be just that much more technically better.
I see. That makes a lot of sense. Mm-hmm. And it seems like everyone's doing like different colors too.
Yeah.
Do you think that's a strategic move?
I would say that color is probably what they're probably going to be using the colors that they're most used to working with in their studios.
Yeah.
But definitely when
this is not their first time painting.
No.
Okay.
All of these artists are established artists in their own right outside of Art Battle, especially Anthony, who we're watching right now.
Yeah.
He is a really well-known Canadian portrait painter, and he's super known for doing all of these blue portraits.
Yeah.
And taking on this very expressionistic kind of way of painting. And by that, I mean
15 minutes left.
Woo!
5 minutes gone. Oh, wow.
Yes.
What's going on here?
So, Soul does this really amazing kind of fusion.
Yeah.
Of just so many different techniques, and often starts with a black and white portrait and then layers on top of it. And and often has this calligraphic element going on, and we can see that already in the face. And I really, this composition is a little strange in that the face is small and central and closer to the bottom of the canvas.
Right.
And I think that that's going to lend itself well because everybody else is painting portraits in portrait orientation.
Yeah.
And he's got his
so far, five out of six is painting some kind of portrait.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Sol has, he's making it that much more different by turning it into this landscape orientation. So even though it's not a landscape, it's called landscape orientation when it's turned on its side.
I see.
Oh, it was
burger?
Right. That was right.
Thick burger.
Thick, juicy burgers from Katie here.
Mm.
And I love seeing her. You can see that she's wiping her brush on her shirt there.
I've seen her dance up there.
Oh, yeah. Katie is one of the artists that really loves to rock the performance aspect of Art Battle. The crowd really tends to connect with her. Why do you think that is? You've seen Katie paint, right?
Yeah. She did a flamingo and a donut. And she won it all.
So why do you think the audience likes Katie?
I think she's a very pretty girl.
She is.
Yeah. She does very pretty painting. So she gets my vote.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. She paints really really fun whimsical pieces.
Yeah.
As well.
True.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
I didn't see this going this way from Stefano. I thought that we were going to get kind of like a lake scene, but now we're getting these cliffs, these fjords.
Yeah.
If you will.
Do you think that's based on a real place?
I hope so. I always want to kind of go visit where Stefano paints.
Yeah.
Wow, check out Natasha.
What's going on?
So she is putting in her shadows now. Mm-hmm. And something that I always love about Natasha is her unconventional use of color. So we can see with the purples and the blues and the yellows, these are not natural colors that you would usually see in life. And it just makes her portraits that much more exciting. What are you liking about it?
I agree. I love all the colors.
Yeah. Color is so good.
She's wearing some kind of red too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I often see that with artists matching their paintings, and I'm always wondering how intentional it is, or if like they just have inceptioned themselves. Oh wow! So Lois is doing not only one but two faces in her 20-minute time frame, so that's kind of a double challenge.
You think that's a lot harder than painting just one face?
Oh, for sure, because you're splitting your time, right?
Yeah.
And something that I really like about Lois's work is that, and all of these artists' Instagrams are available on the Art Battle Toronto Instagram, so if you go there, you'll see all these tagged posts of these artists if you want to see more of their studio work. So Lois, she has a very illustrative style, so it's like leaning, cartoony is not a good word, but...
Yeah, I was just thinking, like, it looks more like that, like a cartoon animation type of drawing. Yeah.
So she does that, and I'm going to use this word juxtapose again.
Right.
It's basically my favorite word to use on in describing or describing art.
Hulkworks.
So she juxtaposes the more illustrative kind of big eyes, cartoony approach with a very painterly way of painting. So lots of application of paint, not being too careful about her line work, very expressive.
I see.
And talking about painterly, Anthony definitely kills it with that. So, halfway mark.
10 minutes.
We're good.
So we have just gotten to the 10-minute mark. Voting, I believe, will be opening in just a few minutes. So make sure that you go to artbattle.com/vote
You guys can vote at home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You'll vote at home, and in that link also is the auction. So not only...
You can buy these paintings?
Yeah, you can buy these paintings. You don't have to be in the room. We will ship them to you. We do a really great flat rate shipping. Because I know that I might bid on this piece. I'm really into it. This piece from Seoul. And it looks like he's using a paint marker.
You guys have to outbid Morgan.
Yeah. I want to take this one home. But look at the line work.
Yeah.
The graphic quality there is really cool.
The juicy burger.
Ooh, juicy burger. And
would you want all of those toppings?
I want even more pickles than this.
You want even more pickles?
Yeah, all the extra pickles.
Yeah.
I do feel like someone would have to unhinge their jaw to get at this burger.
It's one of those burgers you have to squeeze.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Katie usually introduces a whimsical element too. So
yeah.
I'm wondering whether or not the whimsy is just the fact that, like, oh my God, you're painting in a city championship and you're painting a burger. Is that the whimsy and the fun that we
maybe,
get it
maybe
already?
Maybe she's thinking, like, everyone's hungry, right? Some people got off work. They came straight here.
Yeah.
They're hungry for a juicy burger. Maybe I'll take that one home.
Yeah, that's what her vote strategy is. She's appealing to all of the hunger in the crowd.
Oh, we just got it rated by our friend James. Welcome, Raiders.
Welcome.
We're at Art Battle Toronto. Don't forget to go to the link, guys. Go to the link right now. Everyone is painting. They have 20 minutes to paint. We're only 7.5 minutes left.
Yeah, we're cutting close.
Go vote. Yeah.
And we can see Stefano putting in these reflections of water right now and kind of getting these waves going.
Mm-hmm.
I like the level of texture that he's got going on right now. It's nice. You're really getting a sense of the thickness of the paint there.
Everything is just thick. We love thickness. Yeah.
You're going to have
welcome,
me giggling,
James.
I think.
Welcome, James. Welcome.
So
thank you. Thank you for
looks
the
like
thank you. Hope you enjoy
having a slight cam issue. But I'm sure that will be resolved very quickly.
I wish you guys can be here, but shout out to the Twitch community, shout out to the YouTube peeps.
So we will be back in just a few moments. I think that our camera person is just having a slight technical difficulty, but...
Yeah. Should we turn our webcam for them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a great idea.
Yeah.
There we go. You guys can see the crowd.
Yeah. I'll make it big. Look at that. Wow.
Very nice. Very nice. Yeah, you can
see him. I see him. He's still filming. He's at easel number 6 right now.
Yeah, we see. You guys can see the camera guy on the webcam.
Yeah.
Froyo. Five and a half minutes left. I really wish we can show you guys, but...
I'm sure we'll get that resolved in just a minute. For now, though, we can check out this good-looking crowd, and you can see just how packed it is here tonight. We've got lots of art lovers in the audience.
Everyone's vaccinated.
Yep.
Yep.
Vaxxed and ready to party.
Five minutes left. Jamie's.
All right, we have officially wrangled someone to go alert our camera person that their feed has cut so that we'll get it fixed. So I think that we'll be back in just a few moments.
probably turn it on and off again.
Yeah, have you turned it on and turn it back off again? Did you pour water down it?
Oh, no, never. No, no.
Is that, anyone getting that one? And we're back, baby. Same view, just because our operator is standing right beside us. And here we are again. Hello, friends. So we have 3.5 minutes left on the clock in this round of art battle. These artists have had 17 minutes so far. And this is really where they're down to the wire. They're making their final decisions. They're so committed to what they've created already. And basically at this point, it's trying not to screw it up.
Yeah, scooch on closer. I won't bite. There we go.
Yeah, basically at this point, they're just trying not to...
3 minutes left.
Yeah, screw it up. Cause
did you ever see anyone screw it up?
Oh, yes.
Oh, really?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I've seen people... a lot of artists like to do a spatter technique right at the end because it's a great performance aspect.
Yeah.
I've seen artists go way too big with the spatter, and then they end up covering up everything that they've done, and they're left with
hashtag
big muddy
mess.
Oh, yeah.
Lana Rainbow, yeah. Awesome. Hashtag Pride Month.
That's from Lois Mata there. And back with Anthony. And I got to say, I'm loving this pink tone.
Oh, Wendy's liking Soul's painting, too. I think you have someone too big.
Oh.
I don't think she likes that.
Competing. Oh, man. Yeah, I think the use of color here for Anthony with the blue and then those hits of that like yellowy green is really nice.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Wow. Wow, what happened?
Wow.
What did we miss?
Look how tight this is. This is so... freaking technically
20 minutes.
That's wild. Look how specific this line work is. I love the way that he's outlined some of the white in like a gloss black.
Yeah.
This is a really well-built piece.
Do you think he swapped it for another painting when we were looking?
I don't know. Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe this is a studio piece and he's just putting on the finishing
touches. Yeah,
he did
a switcheroo. Maybe he's a magician.
Probably.
Not an
artist.
His
name is Soul. Which kind of... denotes mysticism, right?
Wow.
Oh, man. Look at the control of the brushwork here. Sometimes I...
surgical.
Yeah, exactly. And especially working with a yellow that close to all that black, it's really easy to tint that and make it look gross, but he's so careful with his application.
Wow.
That's a juicy burger.
It looks very shiny.
The shine on the cheese there, I think, is my favorite part.
Yeah, it's glistening.
Katie's pieces always make you laugh a little bit. Just
because
they're whimsical. Like, it's pretty whimsical.
I would love to hang her pieces at home.
Right?
Yeah, it just brightens up your mood.
How many more burgers would you eat in your home, in your existence, if you had this hanging there?
I think we're having burgers every day at lunch.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. While looking at this burger.
So good. And again, with the texture from Stefano. Yeah.
Wow, 10.
Ooh.
And let's count it down from 10.
Wow.
incredible performance. Time six. That was insane.
20 minutes, Chris. I can't even do cat eyeliner in 20 minutes. Do you see what we are working with tonight?
Oh, my. Well, the painter's job is done, but it is now your turn to go to work. And what a tough job it is. You have to pick which one of these paintings is your favorite. Remember that the top two from this round and the top two from the second round go through into the third and final round. The third round will be 30 minutes long tonight. Because this is a finals event and it is all champs, we will have a 30-minute final round, so we are going to see some absolutely spectacular work. By the time we get to that point, it's the best of the best of the best. But right now, it is your time to choose. And don't forget, these spectacular paintings can go home with you tonight. They are all available by silent auction right on the exact same place that you cast your vote. You can put your bid on. You can bid on as many paintings as you want. These paintings will be up so that you can view them. They will be in the front room of the Great Hall, which is just through those doors. They will be moved there during the break. If you want to check out the Instagrams of these painters, we have saved you some legwork and listed them all on Art Battle Toronto Instagram, which is at Art Battle Toronto. That's our Instagram, at Art Battle Toronto. And we have listed all of the painters for tonight right there on our page, so you can check them out. All right, you've got just a few minutes to cast your vote. DJ Shira, let's have some voting music. Let's get to work, everybody.
And thus concludes our round number one. Six incredible paintings by six incredible artists. And congrats to those guys. It takes a lot of creativity and courage to step up to the easel in that way, especially in front of the kind of crowd that we have tonight. It is absolutely packed, packed, packed tonight. And so definitely takes nerves of steel to stand up at the easel the way these artists are doing right now. So in order to reward them for their creativity and courage, you definitely gotta... I don't think there's enough pizza.
Oh, okay. Maybe go vote.
Yeah,
instead.
Definitely
yeah.
Go vote.
Yeah.
Give them your virtual pizza. Give them a slice of your virtual pizza love by going to artbattle.com/vote. That is where you'll register. You're going to plug in your phone number, and you will get a text link to vote. We do that so that we can keep it all really by the book and only so you can't vote multiple times. It's related to your phone number. So that's a cool little tech trick that we've been doing. And you can also bid on these works to take them home, and we will ship them to you.
And so voting for the first round closes... very soon, right?
Yes. Voting will be open, I think, through into the second round for the first round.
Okay.
Top two artists, as voted by you guys, will be moving forward to the finals. So
you get to vote for two?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, no, you get to vote for one, but the top two.
We will pick two.
Yeah, so first and second place artists will be moving on to the final. And so vote.
Did you vote?
I haven't voted. Simon took my phone. I'm a little anxious about it because I want to vote, but Simon has my phone.
And you doxed your passcode everyone.
I
did.
So when you're thinking about who you're voting for, not only are you assessing kind of the quality of the works on their own, but also how much you enjoyed the artist, watching the artist paint. Who do you want to see paint again?
You think the performance matters a lot too.
I think so, definitely.
Yeah.
Like, and because some artists like, your eyes are bugging out of your head watching them do what they do, and you're kind of like, how the hell did they do that? Like, we were with Soul.
Right.
We're like, what
right.
is going
right.
on?
Right.
How is he that specific?
I already know how you did. He switched it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, like, Soul is someone that I would love to see paint again. Natasha, I would love to see her paint again. She did, her portrait was just so emotive.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd love to see if she does a, if she gets into the final, if she does a companion piece to that, that's another portrait.
Yeah.
Or if she goes for an animal, which she tends to do.
Stefano with the landscape.
Yeah. And
beautiful.
Yeah, absolutely beautiful. Really feels immersive.
I wish I can vote for album.
Well, I'm not going to say on stream who I'm voting for, because then all my friends who are the artists that are in this round are going to know that I didn't,
I did
or didn't vote for them.
Yeah, only 20 minutes. Exactly. This is not a painting where they had a lot of time to do in their own studio. They did this on stage in 20 minutes.
Look at that three-quarter view from Natasha. So emotional.
Yeah.
And then this is Lois. And just an excellent execution here from Lois, two portraits.
Wow.
And again, in celebration of Pride, it's Pride Pride Month here.
Everywhere.
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 All over.
Yeah.
And, of course, Soul and this super careful technical execution. Just beautiful. And then, of course, Katie's delicious Sky High burger here.
Yeah. Where do you think she got this burger from?
I don't know, but I want to go there.
Yeah?
I want Katie to tell me.
What's your favorite burger place in Toronto?
I'm always a Priest fan. Burger's Priest.
Burger's Priest?
Yeah.
What do you get there? High Priest?
Yep.
High Priest.
Gotta go classic.
Yeah. Shout out to Burger's Priest.
Yeah, shout out to Burger's Priest. Hashtag not spawn.
Hashtag not sponsored. But feel free, Burger's Priest.
Yeah. Get at us.
We'll eat your burgers.
And we can actually see on Natasha's piece there, she had a small card at the top of her easel that is her reference.
A reference.
And that's a relatively new...
You're allowed to do that.
Thing.
Yeah.
That's relatively new at Art Battle. It used to be you just had to paint from your head.
Right.
But now you're able to bring in a printed reference.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, and Chris is still going. That's awesome.
Wow.
Looks like he's adding some additional work in here. Oh, now he's introducing the florals. And right now he's chatting with Andre Kahn, who is a very well-known Toronto artist as well. So Chris Perez, that's his painting, and then chatting with Andre Kahn. And then here we are.
Oh, hi.
Yeah. Look at us. We're so cute.
Yeah.
And there you guys are. You can see the... you can see the stream chat up there.
Cheers.
So we will be
that back. Last one is pretty, Johnny says.
Yeah, it is for sure.
Yeah.
The she's so good. She's so good.
She kills it every time.
Okay, we are just counting the votes and getting ready to reset for round number two.
Oh no. Is it F's in the chat? Are we good? We did get a notification said that we were reconnected, right?
Yes.
Yeah, let us know if we are live. F's
yeah,
in chat
if we cut
now.
At all. I don't think we did, but...
We should be back now, I think. Hopefully.
And I think I'm going to take a short between round break.
Yeah, go for it.
And we
will
be
here.
Back in just a few minutes.
Okay. I'll be here. Hey. We have Cyan Apollo, AJ the technologist.
Hello.
AJ's a mute. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. It's good to see you guys. It's good to have you guys.
You.
Yeah. Yeah. Which painting did you guys like?
Sorry?
Which painting did you guys vote on?
I voted on the... Am I supposed to say? I voted on this one, actually, right here.
Soul,
yeah.
Soul's painting.
Yeah,
oh.
I vote for Soul, too.
Look at Samurai.
They both voted for Soul. Oh.
His work looks really good. I can't wait to see him in the next round.
It's looking like Soul's going into the final round. We're good. We're live.
Yeah,
we cut out there for a moment.
Joshua.
Yeah.
Like the camera cut out, but.
Yeah, the camera cut out too. Yeah.
You were here. The stream was still live. Okay.
Yeah.
Soul was really good.
Yes, yeah. Wendy, vote for Soul. Oh yeah, that's true. There are other really good ones too.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough. It's a tough call. A lot of good paintings here.
Mic on to for them to hear us, right?
They can hear you now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hello.
Perfect. Perfect. Yeah. I'm trying. Yeah. Yeah. But it's So Paula asked like if I like how interactive I am with Twitch chat. I try. Yeah. But we gotta keep it. You know. Keep it wholesome. Keep it PG-13. You know, a lot of the Twitch chatters are. you guys vote on? We have, so that was only round one. We have round two coming up. And then round three. Are there four winners from round one and two? Welcome back. Yeah, Venti, bidding on a painting is shown at the same place where you make your votes. You can see the current bid, you can see the winning bid, you can place your own bid. It's all on the same place where you vote on the paintings. It's just a different tab. Instead of vote, you bid. And
yeah, it's the same link, so when you click the painting, you'll be able to see what's going on in the bids. You'll be able to see basically like the live bids coming in on
that
link.
You just have to, if you're on your phone, just scroll down a tiny bit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I just registered to vote.
Oh. Who did you vote for?
I'm not tallying.
Oh, okay,
how can you
okay,
tell?
Okay. Let's see who wins. You will tell us after the announcement.
No, I can't say at all.
Oh, okay.
You can say, I can't say.
I see. For you want to be politically
who
correct.
Who won?
Yeah,
I'll tell the audience who everybody else voted for, but I'm not going to reveal mine just yet because I don't want my friends to be mad at me.
Of course. you never want to make your friends mad. Venti is all the way from Australia.
Oh, hi, Venti.
Yeah. They're
thanks for joining.
They love Zinger sandwiches. You know the
what's a Zinger sandwich?
Oh, you don't know?
No, I don't know.
It's a spicy chicken sandwich around KFC.
Okay.
Yeah, we have it in Canada. They have it in Australia. Uh-huh. They don't have it in the States.
Oh, so everybody there is missing out.
Yeah, they're missing out. Well, you're missing out, too. You just found out today.
Yeah.
Yeah, you got to check. Do you like spicy chicken sandwich?
I do. That I
do. Oh.
We'll see if we can get Katie to paint us one if she gets into the final.
Spicy zinger sandwich.
Just for Benti.
Good day.
Do we have the winners?
No, this is me opening my own voting link.
Yeah.
Being like, who?
Who do you vote for?
Who are you guys voting for? That's what I want to know. I'm not going to tell you, but I want you to tell me.
Yeah.
I told Ryan.
Yep, yep.
He's keeping my secret right now.
I'm going to keep it a secret. she voted for one of the artists.
One of the artists.
Yeah, one of the artists. Yeah, one
and
of
you,
artists.
Of course, also voted for one of the artists.
One of the artists, yeah. One.
So our next round of artists coming up, we've got all of the easels reset by our wonderful volunteer Luke there. Luke helps keep the show running smoothly.
And we have a wild card.
Yes, we do. So all of the people that were coming in that bought tickets were asked whether or not they wanted to enter for a chance to paint as well. We have one open easel. And it looks like there's been quite a few brave souls that entered their name into the draw. So we'll see who ends up at the wild card.
Or their friends put their names in, right?
That has happened.
Yeah.
That has happened many times.
Okay.
And it's always this moment, and I love it when we pan the camera over to the wild card person, especially if they didn't put their own name in, and they're like, oh my God. And it's like when that person, who didn't even put their own name in, goes up, I'm proud. I am proud of that person.
Great.
Would you ever put your name in the hat for wild card?
I don't want to embarrass the institution.
Well, I have seen some stinker wild cards, so you have to be pretty terrible.
I would be the stinkiest.
So I've seen some not so good wild cards, but I've also seen some absolutely amazing wild cards
as well. I've seen wild cards win.
Yeah, Natasha came in one time as a wild card and won, and it's happened pretty often in a few other cities as well. I think it's happened a few times in Ottawa.
That's not really fair, though, putting her in as a wild card. She's
a heavy
hitter. I know. Yeah.
She did that without telling anybody. And then she ended up painting beside her fiance, who was a pre-selected artist.
And she won.
Yeah, and then she won. So that was pretty epic. And I think that was actually the win that got her spot in the championship event tonight.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that was it.
Yeah. So got six more artists coming up in round number two. At easel number one, we're going to have Matt Casson. And Matt creates really beautiful, almost somber portraits, lots of texture, usually darker colors. And he comes from a life drawing background.
Yeah.
So an artist that works a lot with live models. So his paintings usually feel very true to life and very lively. And then Ray, who we were talking about, who painted on the Porsche Taycans, that is a large scale calligraphic artist. Katrina, who you know.
Yes.
Katrina Canedo.
Alex mentioned. Alex got one of Katrina's paintings. Two, I think.
Nice.
Yeah.
And which ones? Tell us which ones.
Yeah, which one did you get, Alex? I believe one was a bull.
Yeah, she's done some really great bulls. And the bull she did
and
last
portraits
night.
Portraits are very good.
Yeah, she's... Well, she's one of my good friends also, so yeah. I'm like, but it's funny, I don't even need to have a bias about her as a friend because her work is just so good.
Yeah.
And then Rob Nicholson is actually an artist who has traveled down here tonight from Ottawa. So when he first won, he won in January 2020, and he came in as an out-of-town artist and won the whole thing. So he had no fan base in the room at all. And he just walked behind us, actually. That was Rob. So that's a pretty amazing thing to be able to do, to come to a totally different city.
Yeah.
Oh, the Bull and the Business Guy. Yeah, those were really great paintings.
You remember the Business
Guy? Yeah,
I
do.
I don't remember the Business Guy.
It was, he was wearing a black and white suit with a
tie.
Oh,
I remember now. Yeah, yeah. It was her final painting.
Yes.
For the final round.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's for everybody listening.
Hi.
We're talking about which paintings one of our art.
Let's go.
Alex,
I can't wait to do this. Drove 5 hours to get here. I'm ready to paint, baby.
Yes, Rob. We were just talking about you and saying how awesome you are.
that first round was amazing. Those artists are so talented. I'm screwed.
No.
Rob has earned his place not only in this final, but he's also qualified for the final in Ottawa, too. So
wow.
He could take it at any point. He's a really exceptionally talented artist and a really nice guy.
Yeah.
One of the first times that he painted at an art battle, I met him and thought he was a wonderful guy. And then the next time I came, he had drawn a portrait of me in pencil and gave it to me.
Wow.
Yeah, it was really nice.
So nice. Shout out to Rob.
Yeah, shout out to Rob. And then we have Enrique Bravo rounding it out as our fifth and final pre-booked artist.
That guy has already got Venti's vote.
Oh, nice.
Wow.
Awesome.
Doesn't even need to see the painting.
Well, I'm sure Venti will be impressed with the painting, too.
Yes.
Arranging from quick and gestural to intimately detailed, please welcome
Easel number two. He was our winner in September at our Porsche Canada event. He pushes the boundaries of making letters dance. It's a calligraphy composer. Please make some noise for Mateo! Ready to go. And at easel number three, a long, long time Art Battle All-Star. She's a Filipino Canadian artist. Light hair, mirrorless, and tattoo apprentice. At easel number three is the floral fanatic, Katrina Candido!
Say hello!
All right, at easel number four, armed with an eclectic portfolio, this excitable artist hates repetition and loves painting in the moment. Competed many times in Art Battle Ottawa and came to Toronto and won here. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Rob Nicholson.
Let's go.
Your hands together for Enrique Bravo!
Good luck, man.
And at easel number six, armed with just a few minutes of mental preparation, a man who looks like he's got no nerves right now, it's all energy and hype. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Ace!
Our six painters are set. Our DJ is ready.
All right, 20 minutes on the clock. All champs, two of the third and final. You will vote for the winners. Let's count down from five.
All right.
Let's paint.
Let's paint. 20 minutes officially on the clock for round number two of the Art Battle Toronto Championship. One artist tonight will be moving on to the national finals.
Yeah. And we both discussed, we already know who's going to win.
We did.
Yeah.
We were, and I was really, I kept checking our mics. So we have thoughts, we have theories.
Yeah, we have theories. We have ideas, yeah.
And as the round progresses, we would love to hear your thoughts and theories too, and who you guys are loving. Quite a lot of spray paint this round. We've seen, so this is Katrina Canedo, and we're seeing her starting off with some magenta spray and then going in there with an orange paint marker. We can see that she's sketching, I think, a face in a three-quarter view. And look at her.
Very fast.
Yeah, so fast. And getting the proportions right off the bat.
Yeah.
Go, Katrina. Maybe struggling a little bit with the marker over top of that spray paint because this is happening so quickly that the spray paint
hasn't
even had a chance
yet
to dry.
Yeah. Can you scooch on a little closer to me?
Oh, yeah.
I want
scooch,
your face
scooch,
in there.
Scooch.
Yeah.
All right, and this is Ray Mazzieri, a.k.a. Madeo.
Blue Jay.
Blue Jay. We can...
I think there's a Jays game happening today.
Oh, is there?
I think so.
People have to let us know how the Jays are doing. Hopefully, Ray will bring them some magic with his art prowess here. I actually commissioned and bought two Blue Jays pieces from Ray a couple years ago.
Oh.
Yeah. So I'm pretty stoked to see him bringing up that subject matter again. And before I even saw who this was, I'm like, oh, this is Matt. This has got to be Matt Kasson. Very gestural. And when I say gestural, what I mean is immediate movement. So he's painting very quickly to capture kind of the liveliness of the figure.
Okay.
Oh, going blue right away. Lots of blue people.
Yeah.
So far.
Love blue guy.
Yeah. I'm actually an artist that paints only blue people, so.
Really?
Yeah, I have a bias now.
Yeah, I think your Instagram profile picture is a blue person.
Yep. Yeah. Yep. I'm our, Simon likes to joke that I'm our resident bluest.
Bluest.
And
you
now.
Blew us away.
Yeah. Hey, hey.
Yeah.
And now we can see Matt is our bluest up at the easel there. So he's obscured the face a lot already. So looks like that.
Did he not like what he did before?
I don't know. Maybe it's just he's using the drawing as a map. Mm,
this is the wild card.
Ace or eights. But this person has a lot of swag.
Yeah.
And
Ace.
Yeah. And looks like he's going for kind of this graffiti approach.
Yeah.
I think.
How are you liking this wild card so far?
I'm liking the palette choice.
Mm-hmm.
And it's unusual that we see this kind of style of graffiti at Art Battle because usually you would see this executed in spray only.
Okay.
So I like the adventurism here.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I love purple.
That's the second time. You really do love purple.
Anyone uses purple, I like purple.
I know. I love, that's actually one of my favorite colors that's on the table. So yeah. All of these artists get to choose their colors that they go up to the easel with. Okay, Enrique. So Enrique here doing a fairly small figure in a larger environment. And that's pretty typical for Enrique. He really likes to create these immersive scenes.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he works at an airport, I think. And last event that we saw him and that he won, he painted an airport scene. And there was so much, the level of depth was incredible. There were so many different levels of scale, of different sizes of figures. Fading into the background of just this concourse in the airport. It was amazing.
5 minutes gone.
Ooh, it goes so quick.
It goes so
fast.
Even
just for us. So here we have Rob and Rob.
Our favorite, Rob.
I know. We love Rob. And Rob has traveled all the way from Ottawa to paint with us tonight. He won in Toronto in January 2020 and didn't have a built-in audience coming to Toronto and took the whole thing.
I'm sure he has fans in the crowd now.
Yeah, for sure. He last time when he won, I think he did a Gordowney portrait, and I loved it so, so much. More purple.
Yeah, more purple and pink. I'm loving this, yeah.
For sure. I like the orange.
Maybe Rob heard me.
I think he did. He probably did. He's painting this just for you, Ren. The orange in the eyelids is nice as well. And it looks like he's used something to stamp these white circles. I wonder what he's used there. Maybe the bottom of a paint tube, perhaps?
Yeah, we didn't get to, we didn't catch what he did, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I like seeing artists painting in the whites of the
eyes. Be like a beer can kind of thing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And here we are with Kat. And look how much she's advanced. Look how much she has done in this 7-minute painting.
Wow.
Bananas. Wild. It's so stylized, too. It's very, like, you can definitely tell that this is Katrina's work.
Yeah.
And if you want to find her on Instagram, she is at Kat_CEE.
Shout out to Kat.
Shout out to Kat. Oh, look at the colors here.
It's similar to a piece she did before, right?
Yeah. She is really, really good at doing these three-quarter views,
mm-hmm.
Which can be quite a challenge, just proportionally to be able to execute a three-quarter view of a portrait and have it look right.
Yeah, Venti. It hasn't even been 10 minutes, and these paintings are looking amazing.
Yeah. We're 7 minutes in, 8 minutes in. Ooh, check out that turquoise.
Wow.
I love that next to the orange. Wow.
Oh, what's going on here?
Ray, a.k.a. Madeo.
Yeah.
This is sick.
And he's using that calligraphy.
Yeah, and he's so careful with his brush strokes. Look at, like, how steady does your hand have to be able to do this? Especially when you can't really rest your fingers or your hand to steady it because the paint is wet.
I've seen him paint an entire car.
Yeah, that was amazing. He painted the Porsche Taycan and just blew the crowd away. And here we are back with Matt. And Matt has surprised us with his palette tonight.
Yeah.
He's doing... I didn't think that he was going to come in with this bright red, but I really like it. And, of course, he's got the fit to match.
Yeah.
So he's doing this kind of technique where he's, like... I like to call it compartmentalizing shadows, where you're using... You're taking your shadows and kind of creating singular shapes with them. So we can see the impression of the cheek here and then the triangle underneath the nose to show the shadow that's falling underneath the nose. And then same, just the impression of the eyes is just really that triangular shape underneath the eyebrow. And here we are back with our wild card.
Ace.
Yeah, Ace is doing a good job. He's... not falling prey to
not easy.
Yeah, not easy.
Not easy coming out here competing with these amazing artists.
So we just got the announcement. 10 minutes remaining. So I think that means that voting is now open at that link that is on our screen, artbattle.com/vote. So that is where you're going to vote for your favorite artist of this round. The top two artists as voted by the audience will be moving forward into the final to paint once again. And you can also bid on these works to take them home. Ryan, what do you think of what Enrique's got cooking up right now?
Is that a city in the background?
I'm not sure. I think so. I think we're getting a cityscape. Definitely getting the impression of some crowd. Ooh, and he's like drawing with his knife almost.
Yeah.
Very cool. Yeah, he's just like scraping away to create these geometric elements. And if you look at what he's done in the foreground, he's created this sense of distance, and I think it's a floor. I think. Very cool. Almost like a tiled surface. So maybe this is inside. Maybe we're getting... Another airport scene, maybe.
One more time.
Okay, and again,
Rob.
Rob. Again with the unconventional color use in the portraits here, and I'm liking the texture that Rob has introduced into the background here. We can see that he swiped this turquoise over top of that super hot pink. And I like the way that it's leading into the orange in the bottom of the canvas as well, and we can see that that's kind of creating a color harmony between the colors that are in the face already and the colors that are in the background, so creating more of a holistic artwork.
Beautiful.
Giving me Bowie vibes.
Yeah?
I'm getting Bowie.
David Bowie.
Yeah.
Is he alive?
No.
He recently passed.
No?
Yeah.
Oh,
right?
God. I don't know.
I think he recently passed, right?
I don't know. I don't want to embarrass myself on screen.
I called you out.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, no, no. I think he recently passed. Heroes. That song by him.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, and these lips are looking pretty luscious.
Oh, yes.
Oh, you're being called out for not wearing a suit.
Tamosis, Anna, that was the girl that you met that night at the bar.
Oh, hi.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for joining us, Tam. Good to have you here.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, wow. And speaking of harmonizing the background into the portrait, we can see now Katrina has taken this turquoise that's in the background and introduced it into the face in that kind of the highlight underneath the nose.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh, I love it. So good.
Oh?
More spray. Surprise.
Dangerous.
I know, that is a dangerous move. So
yeah.
We're
with 6 minutes left.
What are you guys thinking about this piece? Are you enjoying any particular part of it? Oh, man.
I'm loving this piece.
I know, I almost get like struck and just like not able to talk sometimes when I'm really, really into a piece.
That's what's happening to me. I'm just enjoying the art.
Yeah, it's so, oh man. I'm so jazzed for these guys. They've waited so long for their chance to paint in the finals. And really, the display here tonight in terms of talent is just awesome. They're really making our job easy because we get to comment on great art.
Yeah.
Whoa, Madeo.
Wow.
The introduction of these silver strokes around is so smart because you've got the central bird with really high contrast with these black and blue strokes, but then he's filling everything else out with this silver, and it fills out the canvas, but it doesn't compete with the central image.
It's honestly amazing. I can't believe how they're doing this.
Yeah.
In 15 minutes.
Yeah. Oh man, his hand
everything looks
controls.
Perfect.
His hand controls are absolutely nuts. And you guys can follow him on Instagram at @MEDEIO_ and check out more of his work. He's usually working in a really large scale, so I think this is probably a bit of a challenge for Madeo working on a smaller canvas today. Because your brain as an artist kind of gets used to working at the scale that you're used to, so you change that up, it provides definitely more of a challenge. But it looks like Ray is really rising to the occasion, for sure. Because last time we saw him painting was on the giant car.
Yeah. Yeah. And it was incredibly detailed. Just like this.
Yeah. And I think that this is definitely, this is a smart move as well in terms of subject. And doing this piece in Toronto, I think that it's going to capture a portion
of the
crowd.
The hearts of some sports fans.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, so 4 minutes left on the clock, and we have a lot of looseness going on with Matt's piece here. Mm. And I think that we're going to see him start to tighten this up with this paint marker here. But he might be having a little bit of trouble just because the paint is so wet right now.
Yeah.
And we can see that he's really working that marker there to get everything that he can out of it and bringing that face back. So, Matt.
Yeah, these are things that we don't realize when we're not artists.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's so,
you don't realize,
There's so many different moving parts.
Mm-hmm.
When you're working in the studio, you have time to let the paint dry. And you can layer on top of it as much as you want, but when you're in a 20-minute situation, you have to be working wet on wet, and that presents its own technical challenges. Hey, Ace.
Ace.
What does this say? I want us to zoom out a little bit.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Maybe we'll get a chance to ask
play?
Him.
It looks like P something.
Yeah. I think you're right. I think it's play. Whoa.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. So look at how he's established
it's so deep.
Crowd just with these very abstracted marks.
Yeah.
Wowza. No wonder Enrique has won so many times. He's actually won 3 events in a row of ones that he's participated in. So he's either, every time Enrique has painted, he's either won or has been a finalist. He's only lost one time.
But that goes for almost all the artists here.
Yeah, it's really tough. It's really tough. I know. I could say that about all of them. I'm looking at my notes, and we have a portion called Battle History. And
everyone's very decorated.
Yeah, everyone is very decorated.
So we have like 10 pages.
Yeah, Rob has won, I think, 6 or 7 times at least.
The way this printing progressed, I know. Incredible. And we have Rob.
And we're getting Browse on Fleek here from Rob, too. Oh, I like that he's brought that circular stamp into the cheek.
Yeah.
We're getting a lot of really nice color layering here. And then, again, with your purple, your favorite purple.
Do you think, like, a bigger face also, like, is better?
Yeah. That can really set you apart. Because a lot of the artists that have done portraits here tonight have tended towards maybe a smaller composition.
Yeah.
This one is definitely a braver take on the composition because it takes up so much of the canvas. And so you're really working to make sure... You're really working to make sure that you're representing the scale properly. And I think that Rob is doing a good job here. I like the catch light, that little hit of highlight in the eye there.
Wow.
Oh, man. I think our bias is showing. We're really excited about what Katrina is doing here. And this is kind of a signature move from her, isn't it?
We've seen her do this,
Wild card. That is an ace up there.
Ace in the pocket.
That's right. No small feat to come up and paint against 5 champs, but great job there. And now, audience, you will have to pick which painter do you want to see create another painting tonight. We are going to have 30 minutes in the final round so that these masters can really knock out a gem. And right now is the time to vote for who you think should go through. The top 2 painters in this round will meet the top 2 painters from the first round in the third and final round. So get on your phones. Don't forget to tag us on Instagram at Art Battle Toronto. Also, you can tag the painters. All of their Instagrams are listed on ours. So you can check them out. Tanya, anything else?
Get those roses, make sure you check out the final auction, get those bids in. Each of these paintings tonight created our upcoming silent auction. You can take it home with you, or arrange to pick a vendor. You take cash or credit, whatever you like. So make sure you can take home the painting. If you so desire, you get home as well. You can bid from the comfort of your own home, and you can also vote. So get those representing Toronto in the National Championships next month, July 20th.
All right, July 20th at the Olympic Grand Ballroom. It is going to be
lit.
Absolutely lit. Super fire. All right, Tommy. Tommy, you're going to right now. We are going to announce the winners from the first and the second round in about
guys. Go vote.
Yeah, it really, really matters. We hear from our voting manager, Gina, all the time that the difference between a winning artist and a losing artist is that it can really come down to a single vote. So don't think that your vote doesn't count. If you can't decide, just pick one. Because it really, really matters tonight. One artist will
follow
be moving.
Your heart.
Yeah, follow your heart.
Yeah.
One artist will be moving on to the 2022 National Championship. So they'll be painting with artists from all across Canada, which is really, really exciting. And a great opportunity for these artists to become known in some different areas. And also to just, it's a really special memory, painting in the Nationals. And so when you're voting, keep that in mind. Who do you think deserves that special memory? I've painted in Nationals before, and I was terrible.
What year was that?
I was so bad.
It was 2013. We can go back and look at the footage.
It was 2013.
Yeah.
Thankfully, there was no footage because I was bad.
No.
I had won an event and gotten into the Nationals.
Yeah.
But at that point, I didn't make it, man. It wasn't.
What happened?
It was no good.
Yeah.
You
did a stinker.
I did a total stinker.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Performance issue.
So it gets worse.
Yeah.
I cut my bangs before going.
Okay.
And for anyone that's cut their own bangs before, it's a really nerve-wracking experience. And I hadn't intended to cut asymmetrical bangs.
Yeah.
Which is when it's on, like, the super angle. But I had cut them, like, a little bit angled by accident so that I was like, oh, I might as well commit. So I had fresh bangs that I was really, really self-conscious of. And I think it just, like, I got in my own head from the anxiety from my haircut. And then I just did a terrible job. But it was really special to be able to hang out with the artists who had made it to Nationals. But, yeah, that's my Nationals story.
Shout out to the cameraman.
Yes. Big shout out to the cameraman. He's been doing an absolutely stellar job.
He was our eyes on the floor.
Yes.
And doing all the hard work while we're just sitting here.
And it's hot down there too. Under all the lights.
Yeah. It's all the hot people too, mm-hmm. right? Yeah.
So who are you guys voting for?
Yeah.
We want to know. It's the gimbal doing things on its own.
I think Venti has already casted their vote for Rob.
Nice.
Rob won.
Very nice.
Some of the stream. The chat's heart.
Wow.
Thank you, cameraman. Shout out to cameraman.
Yeah, definitely. Okay, I can't wait to see who it's gonna be. I gotta vote. Oh my god, I almost forgot.
Oh,
we gotta vote.
Who are you voting for?
I'm not telling. You're trying to trick me again. So very shortly, we will be announcing the winning artists from round number one and round number two, the four final artists that will be painting again with an additional 30 minutes and a new blank canvas on the easel. And one artist will be moving on to the national championship taking place on July 20th in Toronto. So we've got lots of really exciting stakes coming up. It's the stuff matters, guys. Get your votes in for sure. Apparently, the auction is really popping off as well. So if you are bidding, when you get outbid, you should be receiving a text that is telling you that you've been outbid so that you can get in on making sure that you don't lose that piece. And you don't need to be in the room to do any bidding. We will ship the work to you. And looks like we're getting some really good bids in. We have our winner announcement coming up very, very shortly.
is being set. We are getting ready here to see the best of the best of the best paint for 30 minutes. Absolute masterpieces coming our way, but the canvases are blank right now. Anything could happen. One of them will be proud of our best.
Have it. Our finalists have been announced. From round number one moving forward, we have the very decorated art battle artist Natasha Dishpan and Anthony Vandertuin. And from Easel, or and from the second round moving forward, we have Katrina Canedo and Enrique Bravo. So truly the best of the best, the cream of the crop. These artists are absolutely stellar, and I cannot wait to see them paint again. I would love to hear from you guys if your picks made it forward into the final round. And who do you think is going to win tonight? Who do you think is going to win, and who do you want to win? Is there a difference between the two? We will be back in just a few short minutes. We're getting the artists to reset their palettes and adding our larger blank canvases to the easels. These guys will have 30 minutes on the clock for the final round. And, yeah, back in just a few minutes for the final round.
Hello, hello. Oh, Peter, welcome, welcome. Big event, yes, big, massive, huge. Let me try hitting refresh. Because I think there we go. How do you guys feel about the winners? Natasha, Anthony, Katrina, Enrique are all going into the final round. One of them will be going to Nationals. Congrats to the winners. They're not done yet. They have to finish the race now. The Tasty Burger made it. No, I don't think so. I didn't hear Katie get called. Did Katie get called? I'm not too sure. I was in the washroom. You are back, Simon. Welcome, welcome, Simon. I don't see the YouTube chat. I only see the Twitch chat. So we are streaming on both YouTube and Twitch at the moment. You can find us at YouTube, Art Battle, and Twitch, Ryan Lutz 1. But hello to the YouTube community. Unfortunately, I don't, I cannot interact with you guys. Next time, for sure. But hello. I hope you guys are comfortable at home, enjoying this Art Battle. We have like probably the best artists in Toronto out today. It was Natasha and Anthony, yeah. So, unfortunately, I don't think Katie made it to the finals. But you are welcome to bid on Katie's painting, a.k.a. the Tasty Burger. And you can have a burger every day. People, hey, YouTubers, yes. Yes, so normally our battle streams on YouTube on their channel. But this is the first time they're on Twitch. And I really want to help grow this art battle community and like their online presence. Because I think it's honestly amazing. Tab was able to make it out here in person last time. Honestly, like if you can't be here in person, this like watching it on stream, this is like the second best, right? Second best. And to some people, maybe it is the best. But we see Katie on screen right now. People, hey, YouTubers. Oh. Katrina just walked behind us. I wish we caught her. Can do like a quick interview. Who do you guys think will take it all today? I think only one prevails. Oh no, Rob didn't make it. Despite Venti voting for Rob. And Morgan's back. Welcome back, Morgan. You want to say hi?
You guys are live. Are you guys live?
Hi.
Katrina. That was Katrina going into the final round.
Thanks, man.
You want to say anything? Any shout-outs?
Shout-outs to my mom.
Another shout-out to mom. We love moms.
My dog Alice.
Shout out to Alice.
My girlfriends that trekked all the way here.
Shout out to girlfriends.
Oh, Bob Ross, yeah.
Definitely shout out to Bob Ross, the original live painter.
Really?
Yeah, well, he.
You know Bob Ross is very popular on Twitch.
Yeah, is he? I didn't know that. Well, like replaying his videos?
What? Well, yeah, like.
Yeah.
Can't do it himself right now.
Yeah.
we're not that technologically advanced.
Yeah. We're working on it, though.
Are we? Are we?
I don't know. Let's get a Bob Ross AI back? Going.
Yeah. Yeah.
In the very least, let's get an AI. An AI with a fan
let's
brush.
Let's just put a happy little tree here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're getting links here.
No. So he's trying to do shout outs.
Nice.
Yeah, but unfortunately he's failing.
Oh.
He's shouting out himself. But we all know Bob Ross.
Yeah.
If you don't know Bob Ross,
yeah.
Bob Ross is amazing.
That's okay. He can shout out himself.
Yeah.
The artists always ask if they can vote for themselves, and I always say that it is encouraged, absolutely encouraged.
Why, if you can't vote for yourself,
me? If I can't vote
no,
for myself?
No, I'm saying like if you don't believe in yourself, then you know.
Then maybe you gotta rethink your battle strategy.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe
yeah.
you gotta just yeah. circle back when yeah. you're in a better headspace.
Yeah, we are our biggest fans, right?
Exactly. Yeah. We gotta and like it takes guts to come do art battle.
Yeah.
So really, you do have to have that kind of element of
yeah.
Excitement.
Even though we don't grow tomatoes at them or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We actually
Has anyone been heckled?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we've had people be heckled before.
No
and
way.
Those people get, or the hecklers get escorted out pretty quickly. We have really good security here. But I've definitely seen artists be heckled.
I've never seen that. It's like an old-time art battle thing?
It's been a few years since it happened. Yeah. And, of course,
we're more civilized now.
Exactly. And that's the risk that you take with any event that is live and serves libations.
Yeah.
Whew, I gotta put my hair up. It's really hot.
It's very hot in here. Things are heating up. Hecklers? I can't. Yeah. Imagine heckling this. Who would do that? We're just here to cheerlead. And an art show, yeah.
The main has been tamed. What would you guys
think? Oh, we just had Natasha pass by, too.
Mm-hmm.
Another finalist.
She seemed so chill. I passed her in the crowd, and I was rushing to get back to you guys.
Yeah.
So I didn't get a chance to say hi, but she was just chill.
Yeah.
Just so chill. She's made it to the finals.
I've done this a few times.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Like, it's no surprise.
Yeah.
It's no surprise.
I'm in the finals. Of course.
It's been a rarity that she's ever not made it to the finals.
Right.
I think maybe once.
Yeah.
In her long and lustrous art battle career. But yeah, this is going to be a really, really great final. We've got Natasha and Anthony.
Natasha. Dude.
Oh yeah, we'll see if we can catch her.
Catch her. Maybe she'll shout out her mom too.
Maybe.
Yeah, we all love our moms.
Yeah. Oh, she's just checking on her brushes.
Yeah,
here.
We definitely don't want to mess with their vibe
or
anything.
No.
Yeah, yeah.
They're in energy cultivating mode.
Yeah.
They're cultivating the correct energy to bring up to the easel. And
we have a character.
Yes. That character is here every month.
I've seen him.
He is a fixture here.
A fixture?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We call him Poncho Guy.
Poncho Guy?
Yeah.
He doesn't have a name.
I'm sure he does.
Yeah.
I don't know his name. No, I haven't ventured.
No one has ever spoken to him.
He's behaving really well tonight. Sometimes he will jump in front of painters, and then people can't watch what they're doing. So I get a little bit annoyed at him sometimes. But
shout out
to
Lucky's mom, too. Another person that loves their mom.
Yeah, cute. Oh, yeah, we can see that Katie's here with her parents there.
Wow.
And her boyfriend, who owns a really great bar in Kensington Market, a bar and restaurant, La Cevicheria.
Oh.
They do karaoke on Saturday nights that is just fire. I have been known to karaoke there myself.
Oh. What is your go-to song?
Oh, Alanis. Alanis Morissette, you ought to know. That right off the bat, I know.
That's
my jam.
Yeah.
What's your karaoke song?
I don't have one.
No?
Yeah, I need to find one.
What do you guys think Ryan's karaoke song should be?
I think the closest one for me would be like maybe Can't Take My Eyes Off You.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Because I just want to get everyone else involved.
Yeah.
So I don't have to sing anymore. Get the better singers involved.
Well, you're getting the vibe going.
Yeah.
So much of karaoke is vibe creation and vibe maintenance.
That's true.
Yeah. I wonder what these guys are going to do. I think that
Natasha looks ready.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like Natasha might do an animal.
Maybe a wolf?
I'd be pretty jazzed for that.
Yeah.
Wolf is a really strong character for her, and she often does those in her studio work.
Oh, Chris is still going.
Yeah. I know. We told him that he was going to have half an hour as an opening artist. We could see that Tanya is telling him to stop.
Is it the same piece?
Yeah, same piece.
He just can't help himself.
It's
changed so much.
Yeah, he just can't help himself. We told him, I was like, if you want, you can paint for 30 minutes before the opening. And he's decided that he wanted to keep working on it, which is just the mark of a passionate artist.
Yeah.
And this piece is also up for silent auction along with all of the other pieces that were created tonight. But this piece in particular is, the auction is going to benefit Project Sunshine, which is a charity that supports children's health initiatives.
Do it for the kids.
And for Tab, karaoke I think is every Saturday at Alyssa Beacheria.
No, I think Tab is asking to go karaoke with you.
When are you
down to go karaoke?
I do have my grandma's 95th
so you
birthday
make sure
this
Morgan.
Weekend, but 2 weeks from now, when my schedule's open. Yeah, let's do it.
Yeah, let's go.
It's the food is amazing there too. All right.
Well, we gotta turn them up, right? Let's paint. What's happening?
We now have 30 minutes on the clock for these four finalists. Natasha, Anthony, Katrina, and Enrique. All four of these artists are really well-decorated AB vets, so they know what they're doing up here.
We have the winners from round one and two.
Yeah.
Competing for one spot.
One spot
one
in
spot.
The Nationals.
Yeah.
And this artist also has the extra added pressure of representing the hometown at Nationals, because Nationals will be in Toronto.
No pressure.
No pressure. So
welcome,
it looks like
Richie.
Kat is having a little bit of trouble with her paint marker there, working over top of that wet spray paint.
Just like you said before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And here we have Anthony again starting his canvas very similarly to the first round with the Sharpie there. And here we have Natasha going, this is unexpected.
Colors. Yeah.
I don't think I've ever seen her start a painting this way. I'm really excited about it.
I've seen her like drip paint upside down before.
Ooh.
We're going with a lot of prize stuff.
And, interesting start also from Enrique.
How did he do this in a minute?
Yeah, that's a 90-second painting right there. Like, if you cut that out and you framed it, you'd be like, it's a nice little outdoor scene.
Yeah.
90 seconds.
90
wild.
Seconds.
Absolutely wild. I wonder if we're going to get figures in this piece again, or if this is going to be more nature-focused.
It's very unusual to give them 30 minutes, right?
Yes. This is their special treat.
Yeah, so it's almost... And they must have known this coming in. So they should probably prepare something for 30 minutes.
Yeah. Well, I did send an email.
Yeah.
Did they read the email? Who knows?
I know I can't read. I'm sure they did, yeah.
They've been told it was a 30-minute final.
Yeah.
And that can actually present its own challenge, because these guys are used to working in the 20-minute arena.
Yeah.
So you add an extra 10 minutes, and it becomes more of a time management issue.
Mm-hmm.
So you either end up thinking, oh, I could do so much more, and then trying to squeeze that into 10 minutes.
And you might mess up.
Yeah, or you're really well-versed in doing the 20-minute pieces, and then you end up over-painting it and painting it too much.
Like you said, you could mess it up later.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So it's a gift, but it could also be a curse.
There's an old Chinese proverb, Confucius say, I don't remember what he said, but it's something to do with, like, it was a painting, too.
Oh,
like,
was it?
Like, someone painted over a painting, thinking, oh, if I do this, it must make it better, but it ruined it, too.
Ah.
It was like, so I'm sorry, I don't remember the
I'm totally gonna Google that, though.
Yeah. It is related to painting, which is very interesting.
If anybody wants to link that in the chat or give us a quote. Ooh,
wow.
Oh my God. Wow. And so this is really like washy paint. It's really watered down a lot. But the opacity that he's gotten over the initial sketch is really impressive. To get kind of that consistency of that watery paint, but to have it completely covering that black Sharpie.
Yeah, this is totally different from the previous rounds, too, because we have an extra 10 minutes. So they have a lot more time now.
Yeah, that 10 minutes, it really adds up. I'm talking slower because I'm catching myself just being like, whoa.
You're in awe.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm always in awe here.
the way that he's hitting that jawline there. Okay.
Oh.
Now we know.
Some kind of animal. It's looking like, is that an elephant?
I think that it is, maybe I don't want to ruin it.
A stag?
Yes. And it's been a long time, I think, since I've seen Natasha do this animal.
Yeah.
And it's in a totally different way of painting.
Using
like
her
it's
hands.
Still, yeah, it still like looks like her painting, but
yeah.
to start with that rainbow underneath, I don't think I've seen her do that before, and I'm digging it. It's adding depth already.
Everyone's saying so talented.
And Natasha, for anybody that's out there and is
yeah.
wanting a Natasha of their own, I've actually commissioned Natasha for a couple of art pieces.
Yeah.
And she painted my family dog, and she did an octopus painting as well. So
family octopus, too.
Yeah. The family octopus. The family cephalopod. Oh, cool. I think.
Wow. We were just talking about space.
We were just talking about space. Because you're.
That looks like sky.
It does. It's like, and the way that the light is emanating.
Yeah,
off,
it looks like stars.
Yeah, it's really, there's a really good gradient from
mm-hmm.
the blue into the black there. And then there's that hit of our favorite purple there, too.
Yeah.
Enrico does really well with introducing kind of unexpected colors.
Mm-hmm.
And check, like, what is going on here? He's got, I think, three portraits
I think he's taking advantage of the extra time he has.
Yeah, definitely.
Right?
Absolutely. It's so
this
funny.
Is one to watch out for.
Yeah, absolutely. Look at the, like, it's so loose.
Yeah.
But you're still really understanding what it is. Okay, we got a little anger face.
Yeah.
From Catsby's here.
Pouty.
Yeah, pouty.
Yeah.
Again, I'm just catching myself being silent watching.
Yeah.
My whole job is
Trina and Natasha are both using a lot of colors.
Yes,
yeah,
we have
to start with.
That kind of clashing of the lime green and the cerulean and that like magenta hue up top. And then they're all converging in the face.
Yeah.
And
without the face, when she started, it almost gives me like Katie vibes.
Almost gives you which?
Almost gives me like Katie vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very, very, very whimsical. Like
yeah, definitely.
The colors.
And facial hair can be something that's really, really difficult to execute in any setting, in any
mm-hmm.
art setting.
I can't grow facial hair.
Well,
yeah.
Neither can I.
We have that in common.
We do. We
yeah.
do. Thankfully.
Wow.
But yeah, facial hair can be really difficult to paint because a lot of people get really sucked into painting just these tiny, tiny hairs. And then
yeah.
it ends up looking a little bit strange. But
right.
Kat's done a great job here of creating a shape with broader brush strokes and not getting too bogged down into the hair-by-hair detail.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
Wow.
I love it. I hope that Anthony keeps
Everyone's
this.
Everyone's so different, too.
Yeah. Like, I get these fangirl moments at
yeah,
our battle.
Yeah, same.
I really hope that Anthony keeps this this peach pop that's on the nose right now.
If you like it, I believe you can take it home.
Yeah, you can
yeah.
take it home.
I think bidding only starts at 50 bucks?
Yes.
Imagine taking one of these paintings home for 50 bucks.
Yeah. It's a great way to get into collecting at a really accessible
yeah.
level.
Mm-hmm.
And it also goes to support the artists as well. The artists get a portion of the auction.
Yeah.
And they are very happy when they see their work going to good homes, especially if you end up tagging them. I know as an artist, I love that. And I really, there's so many of these pieces that you could just stare at. Like, look at the way that Anthony is just very gently suggesting the eyelids here.
Yeah.
There's good, a good painting often will provide what we like to call eye bounce. So
eye bounce?
Yeah, your eye just kind of goes from different parts
yeah.
of the painting and finds different points of interest. And I think Natasha is particularly masterful at creating a piece that provides a lot of different points of interest. What part of this painting are you really digging right now?
I'm drawn towards the red patch on the
yeah.
forehead right now.
Yeah,
it's scaring me.
It's yeah.
Because I am
so
an animal
vibrant.
Lover. Yeah. Well, what's going on there? I hope the stag is not shocked or anything. I'm hoping the stag is okay. We have 20 minutes.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
I can't even believe that we get to...
10 minutes. 10 minutes passed. Look at Enrique's painting.
Wow.
10 minutes. I can't believe it.
Wow. Look at the way that the sense of light is coming through from this building in the background.
Yeah.
You're really...
Wow.
And even more than that, he's using that as a light source onto these portraits. So you can see that the sides of the portraits that are lighter are also coinciding with that glowing building. So he's really thought this out in a very careful way. I wonder
Absolutely.
Who these people are.
And there's still a lot of negative space.
Yes, there is a lot of negative space.
But yes, 19 minutes left.
Yeah. So I think he'll be able to master that.
I'm pretty sure we're going to see a lot more.
Yeah, I think that he's going to end up filling out all of that white space, all that negative space there, and just creating more points of interest. I think that the artists so far have done a really good job at prioritizing their time usage and kind of getting down the basics first, and then they can go into honing where they want to go next.
And as a reminder for people at home, you can vote and bid on artbattle.com/vote. I think our webcam is a little bit blurry.
Yes.
I'm trying to turn it on and off again.
Sure, good idea. Just press OK and that should reset it.
Boom.
There we go. And the auction link, for those asking, is that same vote link. So artbattle.com/vote is where you'll vote, but also where you can bid. So you just click the picture of the piece that you want to bid on and scroll down just a little tiny bit, and it will say bid there. And you'll be able to see what the current price is and cast your own bids. So who are you guys bidding on? I want to know. Whoa.
Wow.
Wild. Broody.
Samurai.
Yeah.
Ronin.
Oh, my God. Look at this
energy.
My goodness.
I'm a big fan of swords.
Yeah, and you can... Oh, my God. So at first I thought that was like just a directional line.
Yeah.
But once you said samurai, now I understand that it's a sword. Holy. Guys, just want to remind everyone that this is a 13-minute painting at this point.
Yeah, this is like 13
what?
Minutes.
What? I can't even. Oh, my gosh. And the way that Kat harmonizes her pieces by placing all of the colors. She uses such unexpected colors. And then kind of interweaves them throughout the composition to harmonize everything. And here we have Anthony with his brush just chipping in this shadow underneath the chin. That's actually one of my favorite parts of portraits is that chin shadow there, because it kind of sets the tone for everything. Really, because it gives you like the weight of the face.
Yeah.
It makes it seem real. Because if you get that shadow right, then the head seems like it's coming forward.
Yeah. I think you always get it right.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. That's very kind. Oh, man. I love these squared off strokes that he's doing.
Yeah.
Like, if we look at the way the strokes are starting to go into the hair, you can see that they're, like, squared off, and that's definitely a stylistic choice that is indicative of Anthony's studio work as well.
Well, how's our stag doing?
Oh, man. Yes. She just put it down, but I saw Natasha with that fan brush, and any of our Bob Ross fans out there will be familiar with the fan brush, and she just used it inside of the ear to create that wisp of, like, hair texture.
Mm-hmm. Do you think she'll draw some happy little trees?
I don't. I hope. I'm hopeful.
Yeah.
But I think we're going to stay central with the stuff.
Shout out to Bob Ross.
Shout out to Bob Ross and our tasty fan brush. Ooh.
Alizarin Crimson?
Yes, we do have some. Yeah, we do. I think that is actually an Alizarin Crimson in that kind of like brownish.
I learned all these from Bob Ross.
Amazing, amazing. So you were saying, I don't know anything about art, and then he's throwing out Alizarin Crimson.
I love Bob Ross because he's not upset when I make a mistake.
Because
it's just
it's
a happy little
accident. Yeah. And that's something that you really have to embrace in art battle because there's no going back.
Yeah.
You're not
going
to get a fresh canvas. You just have to, if anything's not going correctly on the canvas,
You
have to just go with it.
Kind of like life.
Kind of like life.
Yeah.
Look at all of our tasty paint palettes there, looking like big splats of icing.
Wow.
Whoa, so much has happened. Oh, and we're getting more people. I was wondering if we were going to get more people.
16 minutes in.
This
14 minutes to go.
Wild. I think Enrique has done such a great job. The only thing that I worry about now is that could he potentially overpaint this because it's so good right now?
Right. You want him to just fill in the negative space and just chill.
Yeah, and like finish up your way.
Go around, shake some hands.
And then stop, Enrique.
Yeah.
He's actually wearing his lucky shirt.
Okay.
I've seen him specifically paint in this shirt a few times when he's won Art Battle. So it didn't click
until
today.
I'm sure he washed it.
Yeah, hopefully.
Or does the luck wash away?
I don't know. Maybe it's got spatter from Art Battle's past that is imbuing him with luck. Ah, just wild to me the way that he creates such all of these like abstract little strokes, and they are people. They're somehow people in our brains.
Venti says this painting reminds them of James Bond.
Okay, maybe with the way that the figures are posing.
Mm-hmm. Maybe it looks like some kind of like formal black tie.
Yeah.
Event.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
It's so gestural. The very rapid strokes that Kat tends to do creates such a great sense of movement.
Mm-hmm.
And we can see she's even like scratched into the canvas on that shoulder piece there. Wow. 12 minutes left on the clock.
Yeah. Don't forget to go to artbattle.com/vote. To cast your vote.
And to bid and take these works home. Who wants to
you
see
can own these.
Yeah, who wants to have a
these, yeah.
brooding samurai
I know
on
I
their
do.
Wall forever?
Don't outbid me.
And I love the again, juxtaposition of the lighter, brighter color palettes with this mood. It's very interesting to me, this the pink and the blue and the green, and then the intensity of this character's mood contrasting that.
Yeah, plenty of time left, too.
Oh, man. 11 minutes left. And she's even getting in there with her hands,
too.
There's
a lot of splatter.
Yeah, she just, what is that? What has she got? Is it a brush?
Yeah.
I've seen some artists use
blood
paint.
Blood splatter.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah.
I've seen some artists use like toothbrushes to do their spatter before. I think one thing that's really impressive about Katrina is that she switches between techniques so quickly. So she could go from working in a tight and illustrative way in the face to doing this spatter to working with a palette knife. All in the space of 40 seconds.
Yeah.
And that's just the way her brain works. I'm so impressed by that.
Normally, they would be close to done by now.
Yeah, normally they would only have 20 seconds.
Yeah.
But now we got 10 minutes and 20.
They're in overtime.
They are in OT.
Yeah. This is for all the marbles.
It is for all the freaking Marvels.
Yeah.
So again, to remind everyone, the top artist as voted by you guys.
Yeah.
From this round.
Power to the people.
Power to the people. We'll be representing Toronto in the 2022 Canadian National Championship.
Yes.
And the Canadian Nationals is taking place in Toronto on July 20th. Go to artbattle.com to hang out with us on the stream again, and also to purchase tickets if you're in the city.
Kind of Lady in Water vibes.
Yes.
Spooky.
Yeah, we're definitely getting a spookiness here.
Yeah.
And I dig that. I like that it's a vibe that isn't pandering just a happy portrait. Both Katrina and Anthony have presented
They're artists. They would never pander.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, you can tend to see that at Art Battle, though. It's an easy thing to kind of fall back on, is something that you know is going to win. But I feel like each of these artists is creating uniquely challenging work, and it's really... I think that
the final round is very different from the other rounds.
It's very different, and I think that that shows a respect for the audience, that they can handle a mature painting.
Yes. We're mature.
We are so mature.
Yeah. We never make fart jokes or anything.
Well, they're not farting around here. Oh, man.
Wow.
The nose. Look at the highlight on that nostril. Oh, man. Oh, man.
Welcome,
this is going to be a tough choice, guys. Who are you guys going to vote for?
Yeah, who are you guys thinking? 8 minutes to go.
8 minutes to go.
You don't have to decide now.
Yeah, don't have to decide now. But
don't forget to vote. Go to artbattle.com/vote. Sign up. Be ready to vote.
And choose who's going to represent Toronto in the national championship. It's going to be...
I know you guys are watching from all around the world, but today, you're picking a winner for Toronto.
And it matters.
Every
single vote matters.
Yes.
We often have a single vote being the deciding factor.
Yeah, I never knew that.
Yeah, it happens all the time.
Yeah.
It happens almost every time I stream.
Really?
Yeah. Almost every time I stream, our voting manager, Gina, will pop into the chat and she'll say, to me privately, and she'll say, like, oh, my God, it's between one or two votes for first and second place.
It's so sad if that happens.
I don't know if it's sad or if it's just, like, fate. It's just, but then it's, then it becomes... the refrain of vote, 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 vote.
Yeah,
because there are definitely people that are watching that don't want to vote because they don't want to decide.
Yeah.
But just pick somebody. Pick somebody.
Just
it
pick
matters.
Somebody. Follow your heart.
Exactly.
Yeah,
go
follow
with your gut.
Your intuition.
Whoa. Check this out. Is this? Wow. So he's introduced a tree now as a way of... balancing the composition between the figures and then the other side of the canvas.
Yeah, what are the figures on the side?
I don't know. I want to talk to Enrique after.
It seems like to be some kind of like dinner party kind of thing on the garden.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's so wonderful at creating these crowd scenes and also creating a little bit of a sense of mystery, I think, with this painting in particular.
It's beautiful.
The highlights on the cheeks, I think, is what's really doing it for me in this piece. That and the sense of glow. And I want to know what's going on the roof. Is the building on...
The roof is on fire.
The roof is on fire. Oh, man. Speaking of on fire, I think every time we've circled back to Katrina's, I've just said, oh, man. Wow, 5 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock. Ooh, check out the addition of this orange into the face.
Well, she does like orange.
She does like orange. And the way that orange is playing with the like highlighter green is so nice. Oh, man. I know it would be too much for my brain, but I kind of wish that we could have individual cameras on all of them at once so that we never missed a stroke.
Yeah.
It would be so overstimulating, though.
5 minutes left.
Yeah. Oh, man. These are high stakes. Yeah.
I wish they can all go to the finals.
I know.
Yeah.
The emotive quality of this portrait from Anthony is really something. There's kind of like a somberness to it, and it like in a way reminds me of like Roman sculpture.
Right.
Like when you see the sculptures of
they're very lifeless.
Or not lifeless, but there's like a quality of the like Roman saints or Italian sculptures of saints where they have their head just slightly bowed, and it's femininity. And I'm definitely getting that vibe here, and it's interesting because I'm perceiving this painting and the skin as being very smooth, but it's actually rough in the application.
Right.
Pretty cool.
I think the lack of like pupil and stuff kind of spooks me.
I feel like the eyelids are closed. Do you think they're open? I feel like the eyelids are closed.
Oh.
And she's like looking downward.
Yeah.
But yeah, it gives a completely different vibe if you think of it as being like blank eyeball.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
And then it's all up to everyone's interpretation too, right? Like how are you perceiving the painting in your own
space?
This
stag is coming alive.
Oh my god. Look at the little
I can't believe the progression. Yeah.
I know the little flecks of green in the eye there. And that red is so strong. Look how clean she is too. Her outfit is completely clean. Pro. Such a pro. And we're getting this spattering technique from Natasha as well. In our final 3 minutes here, these are just her finishing touches.
Wow.
Stunning.
Just under 3 minutes.
Absolutely wild. Vote, guys.
Yes.
We want to see you vote. I know I'm going to have a really hard time voting. I'm really digging all of these guys. And I think that each is going to appeal to the crowd in a different way.
Absolutely. I think so, too.
Yeah. Katrina and Anthony have both presented kind of more challenging portraits rather than just your, like, standard beautiful woman portrait.
Yeah.
And so I think that will kind of divide our portrait lovers there. And then we have the animal representation from Natasha, which I think is also going to be really appealing to the color lovers.
Yeah.
And then
I love color.
This scene from Enrique is just really transporting you into a totally different space, which I think is a special talent for an artist.
I'm more blown away at how he did this in under 30 minutes.
Like, what?
Yeah, I don't understand this.
Absolutely bananas.
I know that we kind of watched them do it, but I still don't believe it.
I know.
Yeah.
The beauty of art battle.
We're closing on the final minute. Looks like Katrina's feeling pretty good.
Yeah, she seems really chill. Sometimes Kat makes faces when she's painting, and I always like that. That's her, like, contemplative faces.
Mm-hmm. Because, like you said, you don't want to screw up the painting at this point.
Yeah, it's so...
Yeah.
At this point, this is when your energy really wants to, like, go really fast and do a bunch of stuff to finish it. But you have to be so careful with your decisions so you don't mess it up.
Okay, now I'm seeing it's closed eyelids. It is closed eyelids, yes.
Russians down in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Russians down!
Mackenzie's going through to the national championships. Four fantastic jobs here, like studio painting quality here at Great Hall tonight. An absolutely outstanding, smashing Tuesday evening in Toronto. This is how we find out who Toronto's best live painter is, and they have stepped up and hit it out of the park. You have one vote to make, one choice to make. Now, who do you want to see represent Toronto at the national championships?
Get those votes in and get those bids in. Everything you hear tonight is up for silent auction. You can see round one and two in the front room. We will announce the winners of the silent auction after we announce not the winners. We will close the silent auction for round one and two before we announce the winner of round three. And then round three will still open a little bit after that. So get those bids in. You can pick up your art at a later date. Get those bids in. Get those votes in. And we'll see you with tonight's winner, tonight's champion. DJ M. Shearer, turn it up. Give us some voting music.
Don't forget to vote, guys. Go vote. Go vote. This is your chance to vote. And also, if you're interested in painting, I would recommend bidding now and keeping an eye on it.
Yeah, get in there.
Yeah. Me, I'm just...
We're just voting.
Yeah.
We're just voting, just as you guys should be.
Yes.
And for anyone that has joined us on the stream... recently, the link that's on the screen is how you register to vote and also how you view bids and make bids yourself. You don't have to be in the room to collect these works. We will ship them to you.
This is the final round. Yes, this is the final round. Winner goes to Nationals, representing Toronto.
Yeah, they will be representing Toronto in the Nationals, where we'll have tons of artists from all over Canada converging on the city to try to make their mark, try to represent their city, represent their province. Because some championship events are citywide, and then some are regional, and then some are provincial. It all depends on how many events are happening in that area. So, for example, in Ottawa and Toronto, we've had enough events over the past pre-COVID season and this season to constitute a city championship and someone representing that individual city moving on to Nationals.
Mm-hmm.
And then, for example, in... Alberta, we haven't had that many events in too many different cities, so we'll have 10 artists coming from different areas and converging, and then that one artist represents that province.
Yeah. It's a good day to be an artist in Toronto.
Yeah, it's a good day to be an artist in Toronto. Especially one of these top four, and especially like big shout out and congrats to all
Everyone. 12
of our artists tonight, and kudos to our wildcard artists too. That takes
Ace.
Yeah, that takes some guts to do that.
Yeah,
and he did a good job too. But yeah, big shout out and congratulations.
It's been a journey for everyone to get here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just. I get so sentimental at the championship events because I think about like all of these artists over periods of months and in this case years, because we're working off of the 2019-2020 season as well. What it has taken for them to come to this point, and then of course also just being especially grateful to see so many people in the crowd tonight when we weren't able to do live events for so long.
Yeah, yeah. And the Nationals is on July...
July 20th?
Book that in, guys.
Yeah,
July
book that
20th.
In. And let me just retrieve our...
It's happening here.
No, it's not going to be at the Great Hall. I will pull up our info on that.
All this info is on artbattle.com.
Yes, it is. And you can also follow us at ArtBattle on Instagram and at ArtBattle Toronto if you're specifically interested in the Toronto scene.
Yep.
And we do have them all over the world. We have them in Japan. We have them in Australia.
Yeah.
We have them in Mexico. We have one coming up in Serbia in 2 days. So, yeah. Yeah. So, Dragonic is asking you, when are you going
to
paint?
Yeah,
I want to see Ryan paint, too.
The issue is I don't think other people want to see me paint.
Well, we have
that's what I'm worried about.
You
it's
got your base
you
here.
It's just you two that want to see me. Maybe I'll do a private painting for you guys.
Yeah, no more gaming. It'll be painting. So the Nationals on July 20th is going to be at Liberty Grand Governor's Ballroom. Very fancy.
In Toronto.
Yes, in Toronto.
Wow.
Very fancy.
Are we dancing?
Oh, we're definitely going to dance.
Okay.
We're going to waltz to some excellent 90s R&B jams that are techno mixes.
You'll be coming in a backless dress.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Definitely backless.
Yeah.
Is there any other way to go to a ballroom?
There is no other way. There is no other way.
So
Tab was a painter.
Who was a painter?
Tab, Anna.
Oh, yeah.
She was a painter. She is a painter.
Yeah.
She's an artiste.
Has she done Art Battle?
I was trying to get her onto the wild card.
Oh, yeah. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it, Anna. Our opening artist, Chris Perez, who was just he was handing me a card that said Toronto Outdoor Art Exhibition on it and saying, I'm in it. And I was like, yeah, me too. So if anybody is loving Chris's work, you can see it in person at Nathan Phillips Square at the Toronto Outdoor event. And I will be participating as an online artist, so you can check out my work there as well.
Morgan.
Yeah.
Shout out to Morgan.
Yeah. And I'll take a little moment to plug myself. Yeah. My Instagram is on the screen there, Morgan Booth Art.
What kind of art do you do?
I paint portraits of blue people.
Yeah.
It's in the...
You love the Blue Man Group.
I love the Blue Man Group.
I went to see them once.
Couldn't get enough. Did you?
Yeah.
Were they excellent?
They were, yeah. Did you go see them?
No. I dream. It's a dream.
It's a dream. You're saving
to go
it.
Do their portraits.
Yeah.
Yeah, my work is kind of falls under the pop surrealism space. So it's a little bit weird.
Yeah.
And I like it that way. I like it a little weird.
You
I feel like
weird.
all art should be a little bit weird. Just
yeah.
just a touch.
Yeah. Mine is very weird.
Your art is very weird?
I wouldn't call it art.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm intrigued.
Yeah. Did you ever play something called Gartic Bone?
No.
Oh, you should totally play it with your... Because I would love to see, like, artists play Gartic Bone.
Yeah.
So you have a prompt.
Yeah.
And we all write the prompts.
Yeah, yeah.
And they get like shifted around.
Uh-huh.
And you get a prompt from your friend, you draw it, you pass it along, and they write a prompt, like what they think the drawing is.
Yeah.
And then it gets passed along again.
Oh, okay.
And
so
then
it's
use
like
that
a
it's just nice to follow the progression.
Yeah, it's like an improv slap meets broken telephone.
It's broken telephone.
Cool,
yeah.
I like that.
It's just broken telephone.
I feel
but you can play it online because of COVID. We're like
yeah.
super into like doing stuff online to stay connected. Gartic Phone is one of them. Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
I like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to play that.
Yeah. Let's play it.
We got so many plans now. We're going out for karaoke.
Yeah, two plans.
Yeah.
It's already too many for you.
Well, both of us talking about being introverts.
Yeah, yeah.
This is our outing.
And we will be at the Nationals.
Yes.
Yes.
We will be at the Nationals.
Yeah.
In
just 3 short weeks.
Yeah. It's yeah. Oh, my gosh. That's
yeah,
coming up
weeks.
So soon.
3 weeks passes by so fast.
It really does.
Yeah.
And for the artists...
It's just a few burgers.
Yeah, for the artist that wins, they're only going to have 3 weeks to prepare.
Yeah.
And then there's also still qualifying events that are happening.
Mm-hmm.
Like the Ottawa and the Hamilton events are happening on Thursday. So those artists will have even less time to prepare.
Yeah. We're going to get the votes in very soon now.
Yeah, winner announcement is imminent.
Yeah. So if you haven't voted, go vote. This is your last chance. Artbattle.com /vote.
The announcement is coming very, very quickly. I'm seeing lots of background stuff happening from our Art Battle co-founder Simon Plashk is there. I believe that he has just been told who the winning artist is.
Oh.
Who's it going to be? I think so.
Very exciting.
Yeah. We're seeing our camera people are readying themselves.
Yeah.
Oh, I love we're getting some great shots. We're seeing that Enrique is proudly standing
amazing.
By his painting.
Yeah.
And I think possibly with one of maybe the buyer. So auction is still open, but maybe that's the top bidder there.
Yeah.
It's really cool. Like one of the really, and I'm not even just trying to plug the auction right now. One of the really cool things about buying a piece at Art Battle is you saw that piece being born.
Yeah.
And that piece represents a specific memory for you.
It's an experience.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a memory. And it's a beautiful piece of art.
Here it is.
Before we get to announcing the winner, I want to show our
It is well worth it, and that event is brought to you by Porsche Canada again, and they are providing a very big cash prize for the winner of the national championship. So we are really excited. Of course, the winner here tonight receives the cash prize, the title of Art Battle Toronto Champion, and a spot at the national championship. But, Tanya, I have to confess something.
Uh-oh, tell me, Chris, what you got?
I've been keeping a secret from you and from everyone.
Chris?
Yes, sir. I know I should have told you about it, it's just better this way.
Okay, well, can you tell me now?
Yes, I can.
Okay. What is it?
Toronto has two spots at the national championship. Yeah. Yeah, it's just the way the math worked out this year. With the number of cities we had, and Toronto being the host city, there are two spots at the national championship. So the first place finisher tonight will win the cash prize and the title of Art Battle Champion and go to the national championships. And the second place finisher will also go to the national championship this year.
Wow, that's huge!
It's huge. It's huge.
Amazing.
All right.
Okay, let's get into it.
That's it.
Thank you.
amazing paintings that are being auctioned off. And we also have this painting by Chris Perez going to the benefit only of Project Sunshine. So get your prints in there, you can take your paintings home tonight. Get home safe, everyone. Thanks for joining us once again on a Tuesday night. Thanks to Ed Sheer, thanks to Morgan and Ryan for doing the live stream commentary. Thanks to Simon for doing all the behind the scenes stuff. Thanks to Luke and Harriet.
All right. Wow. That was an incredible event.
I'm still in shock.
Me too.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
I'm so happy.
To Enrique and to Katrina, two artists who will be moving forward to the Canadian National Championship on July 20th at the Liberty Grand Ballroom. Wow, 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 wow. Stunned.
Yeah.
Amazed.
Yeah. Enrique's painting was amazing.
Yeah, it was nuts. Like, the level of different areas of depth that he created. Mm-hmm. I still can't get over the glow from the windows. And then our three mysterious figures, and then that was balanced by the tree.
Yeah. We never figured out what the mysterious figures mean.
I know. Yeah. We gotta hit up Enrique and see if we can do a little social media interview with him later.
Yeah.
And for anybody who wants to check out any of the artists who painted tonight, if you go to the Art Battle Toronto Instagram, at Art Battle Toronto, we have all of the artists tagged in posts with links to their work. So please make sure that you go and support them with likes and follows. They work really hard. So thank you so, so much to everybody who stayed in the stream with us and watched all of the incredible paint fly. It's been a lot of fun.
Thank you guys for hanging out.
Your community is great.
Unfortunately, we don't see the YouTube chat. Maybe next time we'll pull up the YouTube chat as well, and we'll connect with the YouTube community.
Yeah,
but
shout out
to the YouTube community, Facebook as well. The Twitch people like Tom, Simon, Venti, Alex, Wendy, Feb, Anna.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really, it's been a lot of fun interacting with everybody tonight, and we're super grateful and can't wait to do it again.
Yeah, we're honestly so happy we can bring this to you guys. I try to bring everyone here physically, but it's just not possible. Yeah, I wish I could. So the next best thing is we share with you guys online.
And I think we did a good job tonight, too.
I think you did an amazing job. Yeah.
I think you did great, too.
I'm just here to... I don't know.